Welcome to the Red Cup tonight, but we in live full effect. We got five first team All-Americans, man, that took the picture. First team All-Mets, man, you know what I'm saying? And we got just a hell of a cast tonight, man. My man Big Tree, Donald Hodge, Brian Chase, Charlie Moe, and my motherfucking man, Money Moe. We're gonna let you start this off, man, just talking about, you know what I'm saying, just coming home, man, and playing that game, the coolest day, but the atmosphere, like, how you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
How do you feel about that, man?
Oh, man, like I was telling you earlier, man, it's definitely a beautiful thing that you guys got going, B. Chase and my man right here. You know, it's something that, you know, always been needed, you know, for as far as guys just coming back together, man, getting to mingle and talk about old times and just kicking. And it's good to stay in shape, man. That's the main thing. Mm-hmm. You want to stay in shape and enjoy it and just have fun, man. I definitely enjoy being back here, man, in my hometown, District of Columbia. Number love for D.C. always, always. And definitely looking forward to playing again in at Chavez, man, and doing what we do.
Yes, indeed. Got Big Tree here, Donald Hodge. 1988 All-American out of Coolidge, straight out of Temple. What's up, Hodge?
Here, yeah, baby.
Yes, indeed.
In the flesh and blessed.
Respect.
Mm-hmm. Like everything y'all doing out here, the Red Cup Hour, I definitely tuned into that. And I couldn't wait to get on the show. I hope we can beat that show y'all had with Mike Graham. I was at that, I was rolling. When he pulled out the motherfucking Popeye chicken wing.
What's up, Mike?
Mike was the soldier, man. You know, Mike was a soldier, man. Great person, man. He just get up and go to Dark Heart Gym every Sunday and deal with these guys, man. Love Mike Graham, man. Yeah.
That's what's up, though, man. Just the platform tonight, you know what I'm saying? We got different, I mean, I feel as though, like, myself, you, Charlie Moore, Moten, same era. Then we got Chase on here, his era. You know what I'm saying? Like, just, have you seen that era play? You know what I'm saying? As far as, like, compared to our era, like, the 90s, the late 90s, 2000?
I haven't seen them guys play. I was kind of moving around a lot, and, you know, living in different parts of the country. And sometimes out of the country, you know what I mean? But I seen Brian Chase play 2 weeks ago when he went around the corner. The Legends Coalition when he went around the corner on my ass. God Almighty.
He went where?
See what I'm saying?
He drove the baseline.
Okay, I'm like,
you know what I mean? We ain't gonna do all that tonight. You know what I mean? I gotta catch up with that. But it's just beautiful basketball, man. It's home basketball. I got a lot of respect for all the guys, man. Legend Coalition gets guys together. Not only the guys that's on the court, but you run into a lot of guys, man. And it's like different for me now, cause it's like, I don't know about for you, but when we used to play, you ain't speak to them motherfuckers from the other teams, you know what I mean?
No, I know. But now
we all grown up, dudes. It's kind of different from me, because I want to come into the game like, man, let's tear these niggas up.
Right,
you know what I'm saying? But when you come into the gym, you see guys that you used to just like, you used to hate them. You ain't hate them, but you knew them niggas, you thought they hated you. Man, we got to get these niggas. You know what I'm saying?
No, you're right.
We got to go in it, but you go in the coalition, it's all love. And you're like, hey, what's up? Mm-hmm. Man, you know that everybody got mutual respect for each other.
Right.
It's all across the board. And I think it's a beautiful thing, you know, that we all come together for something like this. Because, I mean, you got the gym is packed out. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. It's not a big gym, but I mean it's standing room. You know, you can't get a seat in there if you ain't on time. You better be early, because it ain't just people watching their schools play. Mm-hmm. It's like it's a whole collaboration of this. Everybody coming together, man.
Right.
Then you got your good fish sandwiches down there. You know what I'm saying? They try to keep the red cups out. They're doing a good job of that. But, you go to your car or something, you know what I mean? You go to your car, hit the trunk, and then you come back and sit your ass down. Don't
shout out to Muffin Battle. Yeah. Shout out to you. Got security everywhere. MB. MB.
What's up?
Go to your car. MB.
Beautiful thing though, man.
Appreciate that.
But back to what you were saying.
Appreciate that.
Our Earl was better, man. Stop playing.
Stop playing these games.
Our Earl was better, man. I love my man B Chase. Much respect for him. But our Earl was better, man. You look at the stats, man. I look at my junior year. My junior year, man. Might still to this day never been done. All Met team.
Me. Got Big E shit that ain't gonna never be done.
We keep it at home. Let's stay in Dodge. Let's stay in the DMV. We're gonna keep it on. 89. My man Bone right there. Mike Smith, the animal. Grant Hill. George Lynch.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Oxon Hill, Mike Tate.
Yeah, my motherfucking man.
Mike, what's up, Mike?
Friendly Dickie Simpkins.
Yeah.
My man Ray Slater. What's up, Ray Slater? Ain't nobody forget about you.
That's the mom right there.
You know? With the coach, Mike McLeese. Out of Dunbar.
Yeah. We are always mentioned, you know, somewhere, Sam. My bad. Go ahead, finish.
Yeah, out of Dunbar. So, you know, and that's like six dudes. Oh, I'm sorry. Man, my bad. And you had a great career. You was a great coach. Much respect. I love you like a brother. Monty Williams.
Yeah, you forgot
Monty. Don't get it twisted.
Yeah, no boy.
That's the mob we had.
And guess what? You missed one, too.
Give me another one.
Earn Bain.
Yeah. The Larry Bird, who we thought was the Larry Bird down this way. Earn Bain.
Couldn't stand, man.
You know? So, you know, we had a good mob, man. Good mob, man. You know, respect to you. Respect the youngest man, but you know, we didn't have access to this.
Earn Bain, man. That kid used to give me fits out there. Go there, smooth.
That was your problem.
What's that?
Earn Bain was your problem.
Nah, he wasn't my problem. He was slick. Okay. He balled.
He got you fucked up by saying that.
Nah. He didn't answer the question.
I'm just asking the question.
Credit where credit is due. Earl Bain was tough. When Lawrence was brought his name up,
was he a problem?
The boy was tough. He wasn't at that level. He wasn't scared. He played different. And villain, did he go to Villanova?
Yeah,
he played a little different. Then I think he got caught up in the numbers up there. Mm-hmm. But high school, come on, that man, he was a problem.
Yeah, he was a problem. He was tough.
You know, he played with Dennis and them up there. Mm-hmm. And Dennis, that was a whole nother problem. 3D, high school,
serious.
Talking about high school, that man was the player of the year nationwide. People forget that.
Dennis was a bad boy, man.
And he was banging on cats and catching alleys and all. He was the fat dude doing crazy stuff.
And you
walk in the gym. This is why he was my man. You walk into the gym with Dennis, and you know, you warm it up. He might be warmed up talking to cats on the side, but he's shooting. This nigga don't miss a shot.
Yeah.
And I'm talking about he at half court. Yeah, man, what's up, man? We'll see y'all later. I'm like, water. I'm like, we gotta pay this nigga here.
What about having Tucker?
Tucker was a beast. Tucker was tough. Definitely. They had a whole squad. They had a mean squad. We luckily squeaked by them, but I mean, the year we won it, they had a monster squad with him, Keith Jackson, scoring ass nigga, man.
Orlando Vegas, I was looking for him last week, he said he was coming up, but Orlando Vegas, I'm saying,
they came into our, you know, we first opened our gym, we played in the first game, they got us up in there, they came out with this crazy ass press, I'm talking about these cats are like D1 hoopers,
right.
You know, so it was tough, we got them in the end, because we went down there and played, goddamn, and then we got them in the playoffs, you know, but
you know, that was just coaching. We had a better coach.
So what was the toughest matchup in high school?
The math.
Now, you want to one match like Gerard Mustaf, Tucker.
Anybody in high school.
You talking about anybody in the country?
No, locally. I'm saying locally?
Morgan Wooten. There wasn't nobody else but Morgan Wooten. You talking about in high school?
I'm talking about who the fuck guarding you. Like, your toughest matchup as far as guarding you.
It was Morgan Wooten.
I mean, I'm just being honest. You know what I'm saying? That if we talking about,
he knew how to play.
You know what I mean? I never beat that dude, man. Morgan Wooten, man. I swear, man. Gerard was tough. You know, he got out on me in the championship game a little bit, but I go into the game. Morgan Wooten, you know what I mean? So I'm like, these cats gonna double team me. You know, I'm going to, we be practicing as if they gonna double team me and all that. He played tricks with us. No double team. Yeah. So it's like, no double team. And then I got my guards, they playing like it's a double team. They ain't shooting. They double team. They not double team me. They not giving me the ball. You know what I'm saying? They not recognize the whole thing. So they launching. And, you know, but nah, I ain't taking nothing with Gerard. That's my man. That's right. My brother.
Hey, let's get this clear. Yeah. I wasn't on that team. We would have won
for
that.
For sure.
Let's get that clear.
But we did go undefeated that year, though. We went undefeated in the city. The only time we lost out Vegas. And we lost out Vegas and we lost that championship game, man. But we almost pulled the spin gun off that year where they went undefeated. You know what I mean? So, yeah, but as far as, you know, because the system that we had, it wasn't like, you know, the system was get the ball to me. You know, I'm going to do my thing or I'm going to find the secondary, you know, person. We had the Hatcher brothers on our squad. Come on, man. Charles, crazy. Mm-hmm. And he had that jump shot where he probably, when he shoot his jump shot, he jumps so high, he's still bouncing.
Yeah.
Like, you know, he's still bouncing, you know. He let his form go, and he's still bouncing. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, I was like, that's my man. But, you know, other than that, yeah. I mean, it had some tough guys to play with, but it was like playing the inner high at that time. I ain't gonna say it was easy for me, but it was, because I'm getting up every Sunday to go down there and play against Mike Graham and John Turner and every Sunday at Don Carr's gym. Yeah. So it was like, we're playing against these grown ass men, and they going at our head, you know what I mean? I come back and play these high school guys. I mean, come on, I'm playing against the monster every Sunday morning, you know what I'm saying? So to go into inner high play, it was like, these ain't the same guys, you know what I mean? Right, so I'm going there with an extra amount of confidence in what I could do, you know what I mean? So, like I said, I could never beat Morgan Wooten. I could never beat DeMarco. And I take some hate and stuff, too. They were trying to get me out there, too, that year. Mm-hmm. I was like, they were trying to get me out there that summer. Like, we had some leagues. And, you know, Gerard, that's my man. We play AAU together coming up, you know. His father passed, rest in peace, but... going into the summer, you know, I saw him and his father out Blair. We just got playing catch up Suitland, right? Mm-hmm. Some white boys out VA. So we dogged them. I ain't really, you know, I drive off 15 or something with them. But I'm focused on the math. And I'm like, as soon as I get there, I see Gerard sitting at the front. You know how you go in Blair? I saw Gerard and his father. I ain't even speak to him, I know them from like 13, 15 up, but I couldn't speak to him that day.
Everybody else watching that shit too. They watching that same shit.
So I couldn't speak. I was like, man, I gotta stay focused. I got my dudes talking about, yo, after the game, we going to the mall. Just do your thing. Mm-hmm. We going to the mall, you can buy the whole mall. So I'm like, focused. We going to the joint, and I mean, we battle. Jabob, like, I had a little off game. You know what I'm saying? I think I dropped like 30, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And they called a BS foul on me at the end. You know,
shout out to Black Turd.
Yeah, so they called like a bullshit over the back foul on me at the end of the game. But, you know, just to come out when I fouled out, came out of the game, like a couple of minutes left in the game. And all the high school coaches was up top over there. Mm-hmm. The niggas gave me a stand ovation. I was like, oh, this basketball shit might go somewhere. You know what I mean with that? Yeah, but. Yeah. Definitely, shout out to Rob, man. That was a mean battle. And there was a couple other guys.
Spin Gun guys, they was tough. Ricardo Leonard and Eric Hill. Eric Hill was getting better too because Eric was playing out there. That's the dog card gym.
Ricardo Leonard was skillful. He was tough.
Tucker was a cold beast. We played different positions, but Tucker give anybody problems, you know, back then. You know what I mean? Then you had the Merle cats too. Byron Tucker was tough. God Almighty, that man had a jump shot back then. Yeah, you had some guys that was here. My boy Crawford Palmer, I don't know if y'all remember him. He was down at Doc Cost Gym every Sunday. So we used to be. Yeah, he just seemed like he got shorter as he got older, man. I thought he was 6'10 back then. That man like 6'6, 6'8 or something.
Who's like Crawford? He went to Duke for a minute, right?
Then he went to Rebound.
He went to Stanford, He was a banger. Yeah, he made All American McDonald's that year. Yeah, we had a deep McDonald's squad that year. But like Nash Nasty, toughest dude was Kemp. Wrestling cats, you know.
Kemp.
Kemp. Wrestling cats, Standy Roberts, Lonzo, all them cats. No problem. This nigga Kemp, that was a whole nother beast, man. I'm trying to tell you. Then as far as guards, you know, Chris Jackson, Robert Woods.
Come on, man.
Them two used to play on each other. So my first time going to this Kemp, I'm checking them at the top of the key. And, you know, I'm black 2 days ago because they just coming into the play. You know, Chris Jackson's coming across half court. This is out of Mexico. So, you know. I look up, this nigga swinging on the rim. You know what I'm saying? Because it's like, come across court, this nigga, I'm checking him, my hand literally is on him, then he spins. I'm like, oh, see, this nigga's a problem. That's Ray, man. To this day, that's my man. So,
Yeah,
a bunch of tough guys in your area, man. It's just that, you know, when you have a system, you know, when y'all, everybody know that you got a system, and it's geared to you, and, you know, you really ain't going to have too many problems. If you get in the rock, the way you want to get it, and if you're a scorer and you got certain skills, you ain't gonna have too many problems because this whole system coaches get the ball to Lawrence. Charlie Mo, do your thing. Kurt, y'all got the ball. So, you know what I'm saying? Chase, you got the ball. So, you know, I ain't really had too many problems in high school. It's just the levels. Like I said, it's levels to this stuff, man. You know what I mean?
Yeah. So, Charlie Mo averaged 25?
26, man.
26.
Come on.
28.
Was it 25.8
or was it
26? This is real.
This is real
talk, man.
Yeah. 26 and 28.
I used to look back in them days, man, and can remember, like, you know what I'm saying, back in your high school, when I was the coolest, I used to always see that crash of 28. You get 28.5 and 20, whatever. I was like, these motherfuckers cooking like shit. Yep, but it wasn't a 4 and a 1. You know what I'm saying? It wasn't a 2 or a 3. It was a
backcourt.
It was a 2 and 3.
It was a 2 and a 3. That's a backcourt. Because whoever the point guard was really didn't matter.
But no, he
did.
It was a 2 and a 3. That when you get 2 or 3 average other points, man.
You watching the game.
That's tough. Them niggas was cooked. You know what I'm saying? Like, what was y'all game little situation, man? Going to playing like the public schools. You know what I'm saying? The Dunbars, the Donafors, and all. You know what I'm saying? What was y'all like?
I'll answer that one. I'm gonna give it the same.
Yes, sir.
Curry Holmes had us playing against all inter-high schools preseason games. Mm-hmm. Only time we played in tournaments prior. Like Mount Vernon, we the only, you know, they just called Curl a public school. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Because it was us.
Public Catholics.
Yeah, public Catholic, because it's us. And we played in all that. Then that just prepared us for everything, man. We've been in some tough battles, won some battles, went through battles. It's crazy, man. I'm going to let them talk about it more because we went in games, you know, we wasn't supposed to win. Come back. Yeah.
2020 club. That's what we call it. I don't know why he's being modest. He's gonna be modest tonight. Guaranteed 50 every time that man stepped on the court. We had much respect for everybody that we played against. You know, had a great coach, Carol Holmes, man, who stressed, you know, one of the things I never forget he used to always say was, it's hard but it's fair.
Yeah.
You know, and he used to run the hell out of us, man. And we like, what the hell, man? He running us for a child. Yeah. We getting buggers while he running like this. We doing what we have to do.
This is an all-show.
But at the same time, after that, it's like when we won that championship and we beat the Mantha, and he ran in there and was like, it's hard, but it's fair. We understood what he was talking about.
Yeah.
And, you know, I'm all about teaching the youth, man. We love this game. You know, Charlie coaching now. Yeah. You know, I'm doing my clinics, man. I'm back up in Syracuse. You know, I've been up there for the past 4 months. Got my own sports magazine dealing with youth sports organizations called Sports Express.
Yeah.
Me, Dale Shackelford, and Roosevelt Boyd, three former Syracuse players. And I'm doing clinics, man. I'm here doing the Nike clinic that I did just for girls. 80 girls, man. I love teaching. You know, that's what I'm about. I got a boys clinic coming up in another week. So, you know, it's all about teaching these youth, man, because, you know, it's all about hard work and dedication. This game is not, I mean, it's only for a short period of time, and you really got to cherish it. And I'm talking to the youth, man. I'm all about helping these youngins out, man, and understanding what you put in this game is what you're going to get out of it.
Somebody just texted me, man.
You know, first game I seen, yeah, we played up Curl against Cadoza. Standing room only. Both of us had 32 on it.
My man, Wilm Davis. I remember, Wilm. I love you, Wilm. Hey, Will, I love you. But you don't remember. You bowled me, right? You bowled me.
Yeah.
You bowled me, man, and said, this is what we do uptown, man. And it was all good, right? After I dropped that 28 wheel, we got that victory. And I was like, man, you know, I'm from Catholic school, man, but I'm from Northeast, man. I'm from the city, man. I go to Catholic. I'm at a Catholic public, Will. From that point on, man, it was number love, yo, number love for Cadoza crew.
Yes,
all of y'all, wink, all of y'all.
Yeah,
but it was some good times, man. Good times, good times.
Wink was tough. Wink was tough. Good times, man. Yeah, definitely. Yeah. 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 Definitely.
Yeah. Definitely.
Yeah. Definitely. Yeah. Definitely. Yeah. Definitely. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like, for the record, everybody think that me and Hodge played on the same cooler scene together. We didn't.
Right. Yeah. People don't know.
You know what I'm saying? Right. That's just because it's all, man. Y'all remember, how do you remember we played on the same team and we didn't? Right.
And
you know what I'm saying?
That's a hell of a situation right there.
You might be in a store, people be like, man, I remember you played with Lonzo Moore and John Turner. They thinking I'm Smitty.
Right.
It's like I'm the JT, man. It's like I'm the John Turner, man.
What I'm saying is, as far as like, I said that to let y'all motherfuckers know, if I was on that team with Don Hodge, it would have been definitely like a cakewalk to getting that motherfucking city title.
That's a nice
you know what I'm saying?
That's
I mean,
a nice inside out right
there. Whoa. Real nice. That's real, real nice inside out. Hey, I'm going to
use my spade card on that one. I'm going to take one off.
But seriously though, we didn't pray together, but I'll tell you something about this guy right here, man. My first encounter with this dude, man, who was that, Mackin?
Yep.
We played y'all at Bled.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know who he was, man. You know, we got Carl Weldon on our team. Shout out to Carl. Carl, bow-legged dude. Every bit of 6'4". If he straighten his legs out, he like 6'5". Right, so we got him. We got Byron Hawkins.
I remember
that crazy. Byron Hawkins. And like the first couple of plays of the game, I'm like, this nigga, he ain't come down the court. He in the post. And throw a sweet ass hook shot up. I'm like, who is this little fat motherfucker right here? The God Almighty, man, this man got moves like that shit was some Pat Ewing shit he just did. So I'm like, man, I'm impressed. I'm like, this man get bold.
Oh,
you know what I'm saying? So I'm like, it's just serious. And you know, we played that second year, you know, when they left, we played up what's name when you did Clint dirty. You know, long. I mean, shout out to my man Boo. That's my point guard, but he did him dirty and said we're friends. I mean, he upset we're friends, and we not playing the same team.
And that's why I was like, man, because Coach asked me about you when I was going out. He said, what you thinking about Kirk, man? We thinking about, we talking so to him.
Jarrell.
So I was like, man, that man's a beast. And, you know, our coach, Chaney was asking about you. Up in Temple. Who's asking about you?
That was you was one of the reasons why I could sign with Temple.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
He was asking about you because he had a list. You know, yeah, you, Sam Cassell, yeah, and somebody else mm-hmm. he was looking at. I was like, man, bring them all up here. Oh, Jay.
It was all God.
Jay Bias.
Yeah.
You and Jay Bias on that list. You, Jay Bias, and Sam Cassell. Yeah. I was like, man, bring them all up here.
Shane was looking at like, he was right there. Look, man, we got Hodge up here. We got a mob. All you got to do is get up here. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Home visit. You know what I'm saying? He impressed. You know what I'm saying? My mom was happy.
Nah, he
played with the visit.
He played full.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? I mean, it was crazy, man. I immediately signed. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, damn.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But guys,
y'all saying you would have been able to break that cycle. Eddie broke that cycle up there because Coach was really like on some old not turning the ball over type stuff.
Oh, that's the first thing he told me when he came to see me.
Yeah.
Casey said, one thing I like to start out, don't turn the ball over.
Yeah, because we had the guy up there, man. I remember I was going to practice, man. Mike Harden, point guard, he come up there. He had sat out for a year. But like everywhere I went, he gained weight, sat out, gained weight. But everywhere I went, when I talked to guys on the team, Chris Pochiani, and, you know, I talked to guys, and they asked me, they said, what happened to Mike? I said, Coach, happened to Mike. Mike come down first day of practice with the bat, 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 mm-hmm. and go say, motherfucker, hold up. Get your little ass over here. Bring the ball. And destroy him, man. You know, destroy this game. You know what I'm saying? That's why, you know, you got cats like Eddie Jones that broke him out of that little mold mm-hmm. a little bit. Then you had guards come up there where he let them do their thing and stuff. You know what I mean?
Through you, Eddie and Aaron McKee?
They were up there. I left. They was up there with
Making there.
Kilgore. Yeah, I was making Mick Kilgore. Oh,
Mick was
tough. Shaking, banging,
making. Yep, my man, Big D. Yeah, Coswell. Yeah,
Big Coswell.
Yeah, that's my roommate. Yeah, yeah. So we was up there. We was doing our thing up there. But Eddie and them had to sit out. They was up there. Mm-hmm. They had to sit out.
Yeah,
him and Aaron McKee. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so they had to sit out. We had Vic Karstoffen up there. He had to sit out. Vic was tough, too, though. And the whole Philly thing is just different up there anyway.
Who was there your freshman year
It was me, Mark, and D. Cardswell, Mark Strickland. I left him out. He was on that squad.
Oh, the athletic guy.
Yeah. Mark Strickland was up there. We weren't really that deep, but like Coach ain't really play a lot of guys. He didn't really play a lot of minutes up there. You know what I'm saying? We go seven. If that, seven, we might go six. Seven. You know what I'm saying? So if you're going in, you might come in there for a couple of seconds. The only time you're going in is if you get two fouls in the first half. You're going to sit down no matter what. I don't care what the situation is. You get two fouls in the first minute or two fouls, you're going to sit down. You're going to be pissed. You know what I'm saying? That was his whole rule because he wanted to keep you for the second half. You're not coming out the second half. So we ain't really go that deep up there.
Yeah.
He had his little philosophy, but you know what I'm saying? When we used to rock, you know, we used to rock cats, but you know, like say we go up to Syracuse. We played Billy Owens and them up there. The talent, you know, because you know, I stay deep.
Deep.
You know, they deep.
Train Spars never deep. Stop. Like, train never stop.
They deep. They deep, so the talent comes out.
Hey, love the show. Love the show.
Yeah.
Train never stop.
Never stop.
Never stop.
Yeah, man. So we playing them bigger schools, you know, and not really, you know, they squad. They just go way into their bench. So it's like you gonna get tired if you keep playing against fresh cats that's coming off the bench, fresh. So, you know, we ball with cats and you know. If we can hold them off, we hold them off. But you playing at UNLV. Shout out to Big Dave Butler. And
man,
we
I was going to say that. You know that was my neighbor. That was my neighbor, man.
Yeah,
shout out Big Dave Butler. Much respect. Homie, love you to death.
Larry and all that. We bought them on national TV. But they come in waves, man.
We play tomorrow at 1:30, Dave.
Yeah, we need Dave down there. This is the last weekend for the new guys, too, man. They put that rule in. You got Cardoza that you never, you know, we ain't even know Cardoza enrolled that many students on their team that's out there. My God, man. We had like 30 niggas in blue out there. I mean, purple out there, man. Shout out to Will Davis, Greg Jones, and all them cats out there. Y'all keep recruiting. Let me see if y'all made some new jerseys for tomorrow.
My man,
shout out to Sweatsuit Bill.
Sweatsuit Bill.
There you go.
Sweat.
You can't.
Yeah, man, it's a beautiful thing.
You got
a
stuck on his
from the fifth floor.
Big day. Where your man Derrick Harris at, man? Where your man Derrick Harris?
That's my homie right there. Hey, Lord D, don't, you know what I'm saying? I'm going to holler at you, man.
My man, what's up, Lord D? My name is Derrick Harris. This is an all-no-homo show.
No homos in here. I love ladies, man.
Hey, where Mike Graham at, man? Tell Mike Graham to bring you out that Popeyes over here, man.
Mike Graham, he got the hook up. I just want to say, man, for y'all cats to even mention me
in the same sentence with that man, Mike Graham, man, that shit was an honor,
Mike
man.
Mike Graham was on another level,
mm-hmm. you know. And y'all mentioned it, you were D-Hards. So I was like, y'all from the same category? All right, that's some good shit.
I got a question for you tonight.
Let's roll, man. I got the red cup. Make sure Sam on the record, man. We all know all night. We got Moe and Charlie Moe and them.
I bet we the only show in the country right now got three NBA players on the show right now.
Agree, yeah.
Mavericks, Jazz,
Journeyman,
Vancouver,
everywhere.
Yeah,
where they sign them at.
Homies, legit shit.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? So cut that bullshit out.
Direct deposit.
Man, we getting right to this non-smoking situation. This mother all time, man. You know what I'm saying?
I seen them cats. I did come home and watch that championship game when Don Ford hit that freaky shot. But I'm just saying, this is the all love report I'm giving y'all like this. Because I came to the game and I didn't know anything about Curl. My whole thing was like, Curl like that this year? You know what I mean?
Monster.
Curl wasn't like that for the last couple years.
I come down there and just say you fried Cedric Lewis.
Shout out to my man Cedric. That's my man. Shout out to my man. But all seriousness though, I came down. I went to the championship game, man, and saw y'all bowling, man. I was like, these cats ain't playing, man. And y'all had that thing under control for a long time, but the guy there, that nigga Donald Ford, he was doing some spin joint the whole game. When he was playing with the basketball like he can't dribble, and then spinning and getting to the cup, it was sick. Cause I remember you doing this damn motherfucker. I know Long, you was smoking out there, but I specifically remember Charlie Moe hitting this damn George Gervin finger roll on anything. I was like, man, these little cats serious out here, man.
Can I get him too? Donald Ford, I see you tomorrow.
Yeah, D4, man, stop all that faking out there, for real.
I'll see you tomorrow.
You know, D was there today. He was there today.
He missed the Curl dunk ball game. Curl got paid back last week. Much love. We paid him back. We paid him back. Next year, we get 35 and 34. Much love. Bones at that game. That whole day before Christmas break. That was cool. Them two niggas right there? Nah, they was cooking.
So, they the best 1-2 punch to ever come out of the city?
They not 1-2, they 2-3.
They the best.
Listen to what I'm saying to you. Okay, go ahead.
I said 1-2 punch. That's not a point guard and a shooting guard.
Oh, okay. Right, I see what you're saying. Okay, now I see what you're saying.
A lot of buckets.
You're crazy.
Yeah, because we think about it, it's kind of tough, though. When you think about it.
No, seriously, 100%.
A lot of buzz.
Yeah, that's what I'm asking. That's what I'm asking.
You think, because you know, you're talking about you was a one-man gang. You included guys, but you was basically a one-man gang.
What about
I was like a one-man
gang. What about Baby and Crip?
You talking about duo?
I never said it.
You know, getting it.
So everything for me is that.
Hold on, so Baby and Craig or Lawrence and Mo and
I ain't seen.
I didn't see them guys.
A lot of basketball games with Baby and Craig, but at the same time, I got to go with them. Because of the positions that they play. You know what I'm saying?
You gotta ask the people out there. People out on Facebook land, what they thinking, because, you know, I didn't watch a whole lot of basketball, but when you talk about these cats averaging mid 20s, both of them?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, man, 20, I don't know.
28.
I don't know. You talking about the upper 20s, two cats in one squad? That's a 1-2 punch.
28, 26.
I'm growing. You know what I'm saying?
28, 26, D-Hop.
That's serious. That's numbers right there, man. That's some old Indiana Houston
states. Yeah, some Kiki Van Der Wey and Alexander.
Yeah, we had other players, too. That was average.
All right. Yeah, y'all had them type of players. And y'all was Kiki and motherfucking
them. It had to be with the schedule we had.
My man,
Main
shout
man.
Out to my man, rest in peace, Ty Gibson, man.
Oh, top gun. Oh, man. That top was my gun. Man. Top man. Gun. Come on, top man. Gun.
That was my man. Off the court, respect, that was my man, man. That's like my best friend. And my B-Lo, yeah, those were my men.
Deion, my man, Stretch.
Yeah.
Just stressed him up.
Deion Tucker.
Oh, what's up, Stretch?
He just said, what's up, man?
Big the Stretch.
Yeah.
Too much for Dumba, man.
Let me ask you.
Shout out Jeff Baxter.
This is a question for you.
For me?
Yeah. Lars Moten or Charles Harrison.
What you mean?
Right now.
Depending on what?
It doesn't matter.
Man,
you can't keep asking these fucked up questions and ain't nobody gonna answer fucked up questions.
Let me speak on that.
I'm taking Lars Harrison.
Let me speak on that.
I knew you was good.
Ain't nobody ever breaking this up, man. You can't break this up. Ain't no if. No, this is the bomb forever.
Charles Moten and Lars Harrison.
That's a package deal.
Charles Moten and Lars Harrison.
See what I'm saying?
Package.
You see how petty you are?
Package.
Hey, man,
you petty.
Baggage.
If I don't make an answer, you going to cuss me out.
Hey, but let's go to
tomorrow. Let's
go to the morning.
You ain't getting your social security yet.
Yeah, I'm
ready. You got to give him a question, though. You got to give him a question.
Sponsored by Brownies.
Brownies.
Now, with no bullshit, we got my man Moten on the show, man. Yeah.
Brownies on the
top. This is a hell of a scene right here, man, as far as like.
Oh, man.
Man, these some bad motherfuckers, man. Yeah, no man. Bullshit. Like, bring them back and shit, man, to make shit relevant. Joe, we bad motherfuckers on this panel tonight, man, you know?
Shout out Donald Hodge. See Donald Hodge get that championship and run out of there cold field.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was up there.
You got one.
Yeah, I beat Gonzaga, right?
Hey, you got one. Yeah. Come on, man. That was crazy. That was scary, too. Mark Stillman was out of control.
Mark Tillman was unreal.
Out of control, man. To this day, I got to speak to him every day because he was out of control, man. Seriously, man.
He
was out of control, man.
I said, man.
2 in the morning.
Mark Tillman was right there. Playing against him.
Yeah.
Mark Tillman was out of control, dog.
I got a workout in my man. Had the car, cut the
no answer. Oh man, that first half, that man was running off, falling out of bounds, hitting fadeaways, and it was just crazy, man.
Yeah.
We had Dirk Davis though, so you know what I'm saying. And Dirk hit that game winner, so you know what I mean.
Yeah.
But
what you was in the 10th day year or 11th?
Yeah, that was sophomore year.
You played a lot.
Yeah, I was. We had Big Jew out there. He was a senior, so. He had to stop, so he stopped and played like 2 minutes, and I got in and played the
best. Hey, Jew, hey, Jew, disrespect the
city. Hey, Jew, hey, big homie, set the pick and roll, man.
Set the pick and roll.
You know what I mean?
Oh, set the pick and go set another pick.
They had Jew out there like
set the pick and roll, man.
That's you, man. God damn, I see you soon, man. God damn. That's my man, Big Everett, man. Shout out to Big Everett and his family, moms and sister, man. They used to keep me up. You know, for that little bit of time, I stayed out of trouble when I was with them, man. You know,
big shout out to Ben Guillory, man.
Ben Guillory,
he robbed NBA. He played a tip off a game, getting like $20,000 a game. You my idol, man. Shout out to Ben Guillory.
Hey, let me ask Morton a question real quick. Like, on the Syracuse, man, what made you make that decision to go to Syracuse? And just, did he tell you you just got the green light, you're going to do what you do?
Yeah. You know, a lot of people don't know, Maryland was my first choice. Yeah, you know, I had signed a letter of intent to Maryland. Me and Danielle Marshall had signed.
We my man, Danielle Marshall.
We was going to go to Maryland, man.
Serious.
The next day, they called us back, man, and tell us that our GPAs wasn't high enough. I had like a 2.7, you know, I ain't no stupid dude. Probably like a B minus average, you know. But it was a blessing. And the blessing was I got a chance to get out of the city, man. And, you know, I would have had to give everybody tickets and shit, you know. worry about, you know, all that extra shit instead of staying focused.
Right.
I went up to the Cuse, man, and my man was already up there, Marvin Graves, who played with us at Carroll. You know, he was a quarterback there, and we became roommates.
Bang! You know,
Marvelous Marvin Graves. My man, the real number five. Much love, man. So
they
I went
took
up
me
there.
Out with that bag.
Yes, sir. Went up there, man, and did what we had to do. You know, one of the things, I went to an orange and blue game at Syracuse, and it was a practice, man, and I dropped like 40. So, you know, I remember Dave Johnson, my teammate, telling me, like, man, Mo, coach just grabbed me and brought me in his office. So I was like, DJ, what'd he say, DJ? What'd he say? He said, man, he slammed the door, said, did you see that fucking Moten? We got a baller. So once he told me that, man, I just let it flow, bro.
Yeah. Right.
I just let it flow, played the game, man, you know, and just did what I had to do, you know. My greatest times at the Cuse, man, was truly, you know, Coach Boeheim diagramming a play. And after the play, 1, 2, 3 break, and we go out, and he say, Moten, come here. Mm-hmm. Just get a bucket, son. I don't give a fuck how you doing. That's what Coach Boeheim used to say. And that was my man. I used to love that shit, man. Man, I love that. I gave that extra energy, man, to do what I do, man.
That's
so much love, man. You know, great 4 years there, man. Blessing, you know, surprised a lot of people, you know, becoming the all-time leading scorer in school's history.
Yeah, that's
you know, that was awesome, a lot of great players to come out of there, man. Pearl Washington, Billy Owens, Derek Coleman, Sherman Douglas, Dave Bing. You know,
hey, y'all see Sherman? You know. Sherman on the Sherman's on the Housewives of Potomac. I seen him last week. Stuck on there. Yeah, I ain't got a bad little
joint
on there. Sherman,
yeah.
I see you.
Sherman always had the bag, my man. Much love, Dougie. You always kept it low key, Dougie. Always kept it low key.
Man, the general.
Yeah. Yes, the general, sir. Right there. Yes, sir. Great soldier, man.
Yes, sir.
Yeah,
much love, man.
Yeah, but you know what was weird to me, man? We played at the Cap Center.
That was weird, Mo.
And, you know, we're going through warm-ups, right, Bone?
Mm-hmm.
So, niggas coming up to me now like, man, you better not shake Moten's hand, man. Fuck that shit.
Well, that's what they were telling you up
there? Yeah, I was like, you got jazz hands.
Man, you Hoyas. What the fuck?
Nah, these my niggas, though. Nah, you getting me right for the game.
So, you just telling him that.
Oh, he knew that. I looked at him when I crossed half court. I gave this to my niggas.
I know, you just
but when we go out there for a while. No, I didn't do it.
I learned that. They got to keep that.
That's my man. He always been my man. But
put
you know,
right there.
Y'all tired of
Listen to the story, though, man. That's GT. That's GT. No, listen to the story, man. That's a robbery game, man. Marlon's a king game. Big Monday. Man, we called a Big Monday. Hey, how many years ago was this, though? Nah, but see, I was looking at him like he looking at me. This people's buying Syracuse, man. It's like, yeah, what's up? Yeah, they was gonna haunt. So I was like, yeah, we gonna bust y'all ass tonight, Joe. So I'm looking them off, right? He looking me off, doing it. You know how he do his little dance. So when we come out there for the tip off, Joe, we dap up. And it was off.
Competition, baby. Yeah, always. Man, and that's the blessing, man. That's the blessing. It's all about competition.
Yeah.
Loving the game, man.
What was y'all record against each other at Syracuse? I know I went 4-2
once. I told him at the free throw line I was transferring.
Yes, he did. Yes, he did.
Hey,
yeah,
he
told me.
Hey, hey.
He was gone.
I ain't got nothing to do with this one. I got nothing to do with this
one. A lot of people don't understand, man. My backcourt partner, man, averaged 17 points his freshman year, man. Them some strong numbers.
Hell yeah.
Playing again with Alonzo Mourning, you know, so. I tell people all the time.
Nowadays, that's one and done numbers. Yeah, one and absolutely. Done. Even right now,
one and done. 37 and 8 points.
Yeah. First round, you know what I mean? So that's crazy. They just going off of potential right now. But come on, man. You tell me, you. I mean, the execs do know something, but come on, man. You got guys that's got low numbers and they just say, I'm gone. First round.
But you know, so beyond, like, back in the day, that skill set that yourself and Moten had, that's one and done on the break.
It's one and done on the break.
That's done.
I mean, you know what I'm saying? I'm just saying, it ain't even that.
Cause you talking about back
skill set wise, and just knowing how to play against older guys, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
But that's what one and done was back then.
I see this man get 42 off 16 shots.
Sure.
But you look at it in the scale where
my man get 42.
You didn't have to go to school. You could have went straight out of high school.
Right.
Numbers like that, you know what I'm saying? If we'd have known better, Cass could have just stepped out there. Yeah, you know what I mean? Trust me, and avoided a whole bunch of BS. Like, you could have went after your performances at the Capitol Classic when you tore down my man, Kenny. That's my man. That's my man, Kenny. When you did up dirty like that, you could have said, man, fuck it, I'm going declare for the draft.
Absolutely special.
Back then.
Now you got to go to school.
Back then. Something like that, a performance like that, absolutely. Come on, man. You going to at least get mid first round or something like that. Because, come on, Kenny was projected first round right after school.
So by you having that performance like that,
because I saw that damn game, I'm like, this Nick Curtin.
The business side is totally changed.
Totally, totally different, man. It's all, you know, we know it's about the dinero, the money, but at the same time, you know, the talent, I look at it like this. When we was coming up, you know, much respect to the new era of, you know, computerized things. You know, when we played, you know, and we went to Nike camp, we didn't know how Chris Webber played or Juwan Howard or Jalen Rose. You know, all we knew was their name. And so I really feel it's like you more intense and you more ready.
Yeah.
Now, if you want to know about a player, all you got to do is do this.
Yeah.
You can scout them like this. So they got more scouting report than we did as far as understanding how to be ready.
Coach's jobs was a lot harder back then.
Because we just played back. We just played basketball.
And the coach's jobs was a lot harder.
You had to bring your game. You had to bring your game. It wasn't
basketball.
You ain't had this to see what a nigga was doing. You ain't had this to see what a nigga was doing.
Coaches gets like people, you know, this like top assistant positions, they know they're going to go out there and go see the player, like old school.
Yeah,
and not just on the computer. They might do that on the way to see the player. But the people we know, you know, they out there going hard.
Yeah.
They going we got five first team all matches on here, man.
Hey, go ahead.
Go
got a question for you.
Talk to me, bro.
Did you feel some type of way when Troy Bell challenged your all-time Big East record? Scoring title?
No, not really.
I'm dead serious.
Yeah, no, not really, because at the end of the day, you know,
records are made to be broken.
Records are made to be broken, man, and it wasn't Troy Bell. You know, I'm gonna tell you who was a 100-point shy. The white boy, Lou Herngoni. He was 100-point shy.
Dang.
He the one that, you know, I said,
bartender,
don't let him get it. Anybody, don't let Luke Herngoni.
Why? Why?
Just don't.
Because he Luke Herngoni.
you got to put a race card down here now.
Better than Luke Herngoni.
Yeah, you ain't even saying Herngoni.
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 about it. Hey, let's not talk about her and Gordy. Let's talk about what we doing, man. Fuck that nigga, man. Fuck that nigga, man.
Hey, shout out to my man Stein, man. My man Mike Jenright, man. That's my man. My nigga Grand, yo. I tell you about this dude, man. He used to pick me up after every game, you know, because he was working. And this is my worst critic, you know what I mean? So he used to pick me up after every game. And we get in the car. We going to do what we going to do. We going to, yeah. So he'd be like, man, how the game go tonight? Like, it was all right. So, you know, I mean, we won. It's all right. But I ain't tell him I was doing, I ain't tell him no numbers or nothing. So just recently, like earlier this year, he was like, man, you ain't telling me you was doing all that shit like you was doing. You just getting the car talking about, yeah, game over. I did all right. So I'm like, shout out to my man Mike Jenright, because if he'd have went to the games, he'd have been talking shit to me, them numbers would have went up a little bit, because I know I'd have had to show off for him. Yeah, so, yeah, that's my man. He'd be coming to talk to you at the Coalition.
Yeah.
Little dude, he'd be complaining and stuff about getting me the ball and all this other stuff, what y'all doing and stuff. Yeah. So, my man Stein, man.
You just go ahead and run the point tomorrow, man.
Father time, dog. Father time, Dakota. I can't do none of them things before, but I used to be able to do all that. I bring that ball up a couple of times.
We got the best talent, man, in the DMV, man. Real rap. You know, and that's talking about D.C., Maryland, and Virginia, man. I've been blessed to travel all over this
hell
world,
a platform
man.
Right tonight.
You know, New York, you know, nah, them days over. You know, Chi-Town, much respect, but them days over.
Yeah.
You know, all them other cities, much love. Yeah, DMV, picks, man. D.C., Maryland, Virginia. We got the best talent, man. So you're getting
was real, those real good. Was fun. Those days ever there, or it was because of the hype behind those days?
Back then, it was more hype. You know, as far as, you know, you got good New York talent.
So the talent always so, been it.
Yeah, we had it all the time.
That's what I'm saying.
All the time.
Hey, Rick, let me ask the super producer a question. And all the people out there, when this panel,
oh, shit.
Who you going with the last shot? You need a bucket. You need one bucket to get us out of here. To get us, we good. We need one bucket. Who we going with, baby? Yes, indeed. You know what I'm saying? Who we going with on that situation?
It's your question to answer. He's talking to you.
And what's who?
It doesn't period. Matter. We gotta win the game.
Yeah. You know what? Hey, we ain't gonna ask the producer that.
Put another spin on it. If we all in shape.
Oh, you mean through the
phone? No,
what
do you mean the phone? Talking about.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's
basically. Yeah, right now. Nigga, you still in shape, man. Cut it out, man. This man 19 years old over here, yeah, man.
Sorry.
You can't take over a game. You know what I'm saying?
Look, hey, great kid. Great kid.
Great kid. Come on, man. Yo. I need to pay the time. I'm in this sweat like Murray Curry, man.
You know what?
Your favorite towel, you know what I mean?
Sit Murray and Murray.
Hey, Kirk, go ahead with that.
Man, this football is sponsored by Brownies for real, though.
No, answer that question, though.
What's the question you asked, Shay?
Nigga, you asked the question. What the fuck is you talking about?
Hey, Chase, you tuning up with us out the fridge.
Nah, we're going to talk about, let's talk about Sam with his football up curl, man. People don't know that story a lot, man.
Per athlete.
Much respect.
All met
two times.
All met.
Player of the year, 12th grade. Thank God for that, man. Yeah. You know,
George Michael.
George Michael was a man.
George Michael, one of the best.
He was up curl every other day.
One of the best.
Oh, yeah,
sports
guys.
Ask about all the football.
Yep. Much love,
like,
man.
Damn.
You know,
I started playing James football. Brown.
That's when you thought you was in trouble when somebody pulled you out of class.
Much love for the game. Much love. So, like I said, man. All met, both sports.
Who made you choose basketball?
Ooh, that man upstairs. Rolled with the punches, man, you know. And then when I got to Syracuse, I was going to play both. I went to spring football camp, you know, and then Coach Boeheim, you know, told me, pulled me to the side and was like, Lawrence, there's more money in basketball and less injury.
You know, it made sense at the time, you know. It made sense at the time. So, you know, I thought about it, man. I just decided to stick to basketball. But it's no doubt in my mind that...
You'll play in the NFL.
Oh, ain't no question. Shit, NFL. Yeah.
My senior year high school, y'all understand my senior year high school. 15 touchdowns, 15 interceptions.
I seen him get 5 touchdowns in one school, game.
Man. Football, man. Much blessing, man. Much blessing.
Game bell. 3:30 game. 5 touchdowns in one game.
Much blessing. Much blessing, man.
3 catches, 1 interception, 1 punt return for a touchdown.
For real.
So, you know. Who's
your toughest
matchup, though, Mo?
Toughest matchup, man.
It's in the area. Not
in the area. Okay.
Yeah, just in the area. Like,
toughest matchup.
Bird, bro, or, you know what I'm saying? Just, dang. Yeah, toughest matchup.
Honestly, in the area.
It's cool to say none of them.
Nah, I was. Nobody. Nobody. Now, I thought you was going to say college. Now, college ball.
I know, I was in the area. In the area.
Nah, in the area, you know, I feel like I can get a bucket on anybody.
So, how about yourself and Lonnie Real matchup?
Yeah, I was about to say, that's what
that was like the battle, like, boom, that was, hurt. My bucket was actually coming to see y'all.
Oh, yeah. Y'all can see the battle, huh? Yeah.
You hear what he said?
No, I'm saying I ain't never think, you know, Lonnie was a battle. Much love, respect, L Train, but you know.
No, that's not love, respect. You just said if you was in a battle, that's like you saying.
I just said nobody bone, nobody could guard me. Nobody could guard me.
Say that.
I said it. You know, it ain't. It's a fact. You know, 28. Y'all ain't give me the 10. I averaged 10 rebounds too.
Yeah.
28 and 10. So, you know, I love the game, man. But nobody could, I felt good guard me because my work ethic, I love the game too much, man. I used to play by myself, you know, even when I was young, man. I told myself at the age of 7, I was going to make the NBA. It was either the NBA or the NFL. Shout out to Golden Rule Apartments, where I grew up off of New Jersey Avenue. That's why I had the blessing of Dunbar, McKinley Tech. My mother and father went to McKinley Tech. And I grew up in the Dunbar area, so it was either gonna be both. And the Gonzaga, I was in that Gonzaga mix. So,
you came to Carroll to be with your brother.
Came to Carroll to be with my brother.
Yeah.
You know, cross street from Searson Quarters. You know, so, you know, I had some tough times, man. But I remember being outside by myself, y'all. This for the youth. This is truly for the youth, man. Work on your craft. Truly work on your game if you're trying to get there. It's not this, guys. The PlayStation, leave the PlayStation. You can't do the same shit the PlayStation do. You gotta go out there and get the reps up. Get the shots up. So that's how you're gonna be the best player you can be. Yeah, for real.
So you saying nobody saw you scoring.
Nobody, Bone, I ain't seen it yet.
Yeah,
man. I ain't seen it yet, man. And it's much love and respect.
And I love this conversation because a score like you know what I'm saying? And just for you to say that, like, you know, you gonna score anyway.
Yeah, I wasted motion, man. I'm in attack mode.
Nah, you know why he like that so much?
Because
that's the same way he fucking think.
Yeah, I'm in attack
mode. And I love the answer.
That's why he over there. That's the area for me and Kirk.
It's like this, Bone. Plain and simple. Right now, I love the game so much. I'm passionate about the game. All this, whoever say they can beat me or whatever, I still play 1-on-1 today for love. So I'm here.
Ain't nobody saying nah. Not Lawrence.
Nah.
But with the arrow spin, fade, you know what I'm saying?
Come on, man. Nah. We played on this little squad out. What was we at? Our buoy? This is a while ago. Me, you were back about it, and they picked you up. Lawrence played one game with us, man. I said, this dude is out there. I won't say this nigga out here. He's playing new. He invented some new basketball. This man in corners doing 180 fade jumpers from the corner. I'm like, he's like playing with people out there. I'm watching this guy on the bench. I talked after the game. I said, what you trying to invent some new basketball shit out here? I'm talking about this man catching the ball. He might dribble, take 2 dribbles, and go down to the very corner where you can't even go no more and stop and look this way and jump 180 bolt bombs. I'm like, that's new basketball to me, man. Niggas ain't doing shit like that, though. I've never seen nobody do no shit like that. So me and Lawrence laughed about that shit. So, I mean, come on, man. That's a lot of buckets. You talking about the Big East? Yeah. Every time I see it, we see each other. Remember when we first ran into each other down Sequoias? I'm like, though, you dropped a lot of motherfucking buckets on them people down there. And we catch up. Whenever we see each other, we catch up. And it's mutual respect for each other.
Always.
That's my man, dog. Always. Seeing him all with his camp. That's why I asked him about his camp that he's doing with Nike. I saw him out there. I was working on my little nephew, little knucklehead. And I seen Lawrence over there with his kids. You know, beautiful thing, man. This man put up numbers. Niggas need the respect.
Yeah, no, you know, no, 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 no.
They definitely need the respect. Yeah, yeah, yeah. They're going to respect it. They're going to respect it. And I'm going to tell you why you're going to respect it. Because stats don't lie.
They don't.
Stats don't lie.
They don't.
Hey, talk about your NBA experience a little bit.
Man, like I said, man, I need a paper towel. I sweat like Murray Burry.
Yeah, man, that's what I got. So y'all laughing at me.
But no, I had a ball, man. You know, I might have had too much fun, though. But yeah, you playing against a lot of talent out there, man. And it's like, really, it's another level, man. And
who's your toughest NBA matchup?
Dream. Oh, man. Come on, man. The Large One was tough, man. I'm trying to take good God. Shit.
Dream.
I played against a couple of cats, you know, some top 50 cats. I mean, Dave Robinson was tough, but that nigga weren't no Dream.
Nah.
Pat was tough.
Dream.
He weren't no Dream. Shaq, Cole, Animal. You know what I mean? And that's my man.
Yeah.
Dream. He weren't no Dream.
Swapping.
You know what I'm talking about? Dream doing everything out there. You know, and off the court, perfect gentleman. We'll talk nice to you all game. Yeah, man, how you doing? But Dream, dog. But, you know what I'm saying? Even with saying Dream, it's not the best big man that, you know, that I've seen do work. Best big man, rest in peace, in my opinion, that I've seen. There's a lot of them out there from that era.
Mm-hmm.
Dogface, my nigga Roy Topley, dog.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah. Oh, you was up in Dallas with him, right?
Yeah, he. You know, when I first got there, he got in trouble. You know, he got that band, that lifetime band on him. Yeah, so when I first got up there, he got kicked off the spot. He got kicked off the league. So he came back. So I never, I heard up, I didn't know him like that. So he came back. I think it was Jay Kidd's rookie year. We got Coach Dick Martin down there. He said, I got to get top. So they got him reinstated. And just watching this dude play, man, this nigga was fearless, dog. I'm talking about all the top little cats that was out there. They weren't tripping all those. Nigga was twisted out there. Yeah. Quiet as cat. This man was red cup hour. You know,
not too quiet no more.
Yeah, so it was like, you know.
Sponsored by Brewers.
Yeah,
ain't too quiet no more.
And
we got Roy played off stuff.
Yeah, Roy's a beast with it, man. Cause I'm talking about, you talking about, he knew if he gets you in that post, or he gonna tap you with his shoulder, I mean with his elbow. Once he tap you with that elbow, he know where you at. Like he got this little move, we just go boom. When he hits you with that, it's buckets. And then he's stepping out to the 3-point line. And when he hit the three, he wandered down the sideline. The nigga's so smooth with it, but I tell y'all a story about the dude came to the game lifted. And he would always mess with me. This is why I know he was lifted. Nigga come in there and say, hey, Red Boy, you look like my wife. Like, this guy, I go to Doug Smith. I was like, this nigga tore. So, but even still, we played a game. You know, Jake Kidd, Diamond Cats. So, the nigga was twisted out there. And Jake Kidd throwing passes that ain't nobody going to catch. But the man's hands were so good. The no looks are coming at him. The ball will hit his hand. And it's dropped right in front of him. And he could pick it up because his hands were so good. Now, he's twisted, but the average thing ain't catching these passes. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? But he's so gifted, man. That's my man. Roy Toddy was a cold beast, man. That's my man. Rest in peace, man.
Who's your toughest NBA matchup?
Top. Wow, toughest NBA matchup.
I was blessed to play in the era of MJ. So,
too much to that.
Too much to that. You know, great player, man. But I can honestly say that, true story. The year they won 72-10. You know, we played the guys up in Vancouver. We up 15 points. Bitch ass Greg Anthony.
All right, Greg.
And my man,
that's how
much
go.
Love, much love, Byron Scott. Greg Anthony talking trash. You guys going down in Vancouver country. You guys going down. Make a long story short, Mike Trayball. Trayball again. We down four. He come by. He scored 13 points in like 4 minutes, yo. Yeah. Strong 13 in 4 minutes. We down 4 points with 10 seconds left. He walk over to the bench. I never forget it. My rookie year, I never forget it. I'm sitting. You Greg, you bitch ass Greg Anthony. We sitting. Mike come over. Said, it's the same thing I did to your bitch ass during the summertime. So all y'all just sit here and watch. And Mike gave us the big hand, man. I can honestly say, Charlie, well, that's one time, man. When he did that, yo, yeah. Then it couldn't move, yo.
Oh, man.
Stuck, yo.
This nigga had like Michael Jackson.
Stuck. So we walk out.
Man, Scotty Pippen come right behind and say, man, I don't know why you got the man stuck. That's the whole thing, man. I remember calling my man Tricky. Six one save. You know Tricky, man. MJ real, man.
I saw it live. He real. And he talks shit.
That's why he's tail catch, man.
You playing with MJ too?
Cool, man. Mike, I'm trying to tell you, that's the catch that asked me about Mike. I said, nigga, you watching TV? That shit is, I just got better seats, dog. This motherfucker don't play. You don't talk shit to this nigga, man. You don't talk shit to Mike.
I just got better seats.
You don't talk shit to Mike or Scotty. Them niggas, they on right their mental shit is like, you know, they and it travels down from, you know, and it goes from 1 to the 12, 15 guy on the team, man. It gets all them guys focused, man, and they were serious, you
that's
know what I'm saying?
That's insane out there.
I mean, I'm talking about, and you talking about in that, it's Mike.
One player. D-Hall Challenge, we played in the best herb, man.
Mike knows every detail about the game. That's why Mike was like that. You got Will Badu checking me out there, Joy. And you know, I got sights. The nigga Mike's like, man, it's D-Hall's, man. He wanna go to he tell him what moves I wanna make. And I was like, this nigga scout me. When you get your scouting port in the league, you scout the position. You know, he's looking at the whole book.
Every player.
So he's coaching Will Perdue or Stacey King or what's the other dude?
Luke Long.
He coaching them. He coaching them on the floor. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Mike was serious about that. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? And it went to Pippen, you know what I'm saying? You don't talk shit to Mike and think you're going to get away with it because he's going to get the last word because, you know, he gets the ball. You know what I'm saying?
He's speaking some great shit with that.
Yeah, he is.
You know what I mean?
I'm telling you. Yeah. And that's...
You got first-hand knowledge.
Oh. Yeah, it's serious, man.
He ain't never dug on you, dude.
And don't... Nah, I was lucky. You know what I'm saying? But don't get it twisted, yo. You go out there and you do something to them people... Ask Bradford Smith when he dropped all them numbers on Mike and had to play him again 2 days later.
Absolutely.
Yeah. It ain't happening. Mm. Today he remembers. Remember that decision that you can play him a year later. Mike still gonna remember that shit. Him and Scotty. You know what I mean? We went up there and we beat them in their new gym when they opened that joint. Mike was playing this year. And Masper dropped 50 on that. And but we had to play him a week later down in Dallas. Come on, man. This man wouldn't let Mask get a shot up, Scotty, because they, you know, Popeye Jones was in our squad. Him and Scotty had the same agent. And the agent said niggas on the squad was talking shit to Scotty. You thought that the rookie nigga dropped 50 on you and we beat him up there? And them niggas came to doubt. I think Mask scored like 4 points, man. He, even in garbage time, this nigga
Scotty, man, tried to turn and shoot a little layup. Scotty went up and grabbed that shit out there. And it was one play. I was like, this nigga really serious. It was like a loose ball joint, right? Me and him was going for this joint at half court. This nigga ran so fast. I'm like, go ahead, motherfucker. He grabbed that shit and went dunk. They said that Mass was like, man, he got it. Because Mass is a bad motherfucker, too, though.
Yeah, he was.
You know what I'm saying? Mass was just like, you know. He was just like, but no, but back to the cast was focused, man. They, I mean, from 1 to 15 on that, one of them Chicago squads. They Phil, maybe Phil had something to do with that.
Tells the cook a little something about Mark Macon, man.
That was my man. Mark.
Mark
was tough. Mark was a telling ass nigga too though, but Mark was tough.
Let me strike that from the red cup.
No,
on the court, that's my man.
Y'all always got one of those on your team, man. Y'all always got a telling dude on your team.
Shout him up, man.
Shake it, bake it, bake it, man. Fast dude, man.
How do you do?
I came to watch them on my visit. Up there, man, this man, I was up there the weekend. You know, you go on your visits for school. This nigga didn't miss a shot the whole visit. You know what I'm saying? Going through the whole practice. I seen him. Yeah. He scrimmaging, shooting drills. Mm-hmm. The nigga didn't miss a shot the whole weekend I was up there. He was really focused, you know what I mean? So, quick dude, big guard, good guy. Telling shit, he better than that. When he left school, he stopped telling. But you know, that's my man. Mark was cool. Mark was a cool dude, man.
He ain't cool if he doing
that. Nah, I say he got cool after school. After school, he was tough.
Oh, obviously, we need to talk about somebody else.
Mark was telling, man. Coach had me in that damn office so much up there, man. Sheesh. I'm just sitting on that coach getting yelled at up there. I'm like, goddamn, Mark.
Let me ask you this, man.
What did he tell you? He was telling.
What did he
tell you?
Man, I can't disclose that. What are you telling about the wound? Man, that man was telling. That's what I got to say, man.
But it's a blessing, man, just to get on the court again. The way that nigga was telling, I'm glad I got on the court. You know what I mean? Yeah, you got some cats on the team, man. Come on, man. Yeah. You got some cats that he didn't have to be like that. Come on, you the star of the team. You ain't got to tell all the niggas that's supposed to roll with you. Come on, man.
He said he talking about somebody.
Sure, it's special, man.
Nah, man, that nigga Mark was my man, though. Hey, 100 grand, man. Oh, 100 grand. Man.
Yeah.
And shout out to D Cardswell, my man Strickland. Mike Hart, Mick Kilgore, Blue Eddie, all them cats, they was real. They were real.
At the end of the day, we still got the Big East all-time leading score.
Yes, sir.
On the panel.
Yes, indeed.
And it ain't going to be broke. That record ain't going to be broke.
I'm tired of laughing. Y'all got it.
Oh, what the fuck are you saying, motherfucker?
Don't laugh.
No, y'all got it. I'm tired of laughing. Yeah, for real. Like, I got to take a break, man, from laughing. Y'all play too much, man.
He's hey,
no bullshit.
Just gonna say that
this panel right here,
you
know, Snow Mo.
Yeah,
when Chimo called me today and said, Moten playing, right?
Yeah.
I immediately said, man, tell that nigga, come on the show tonight.
Yeah.
Knew we had Tree coming on, because we never know. Come on, man, right here in town.
I know.
No, he's in town.
Yeah,
you never know.
Yeah. No, I looked at my phone, dog. That was that Krispy Kreme, dog. I checked the Facebook joint. I saw my shit was next to Lawrence. I was like, oh, they trying to pop something more for the niggas, dog.
Yeah, man.
Let's change the game plan.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah, you know my man Sam in the house. Yeah, you know what I mean? But this is our era, Joe, that this... Yeah. Show to you.
I always listen. At the end of the day,
I really didn't. No, I said you would have got fucked around back then.
I hear what you said.
I put the finger on action tree. I got Charlie Moore, Mo set downspin. Don't mind ISO. then your little ass switch on somebody you fucked all around. Like
we I'm knocking that down.
Oh, yeah, yeah, rolling with though. Come on, because you talked about that earlier. You know, man, he might be out there. It might be a mixed in with him and Top Gun out
there. Mentality change.
And then what?
Mentality change.
Him and Mike Smith.
I don't like that right there, Tricky, because you know what I'm saying? It's like, oh, yeah.
Oh, no, but I'm saying, but that's bringing us two together, so we ain't tripping.
That's all kind of good.
We ain't tripping. You know what I'm saying? We talking about back then. We got them all. See, that would have been my man back then anyway.
Mentality change.
That's how I used to roll back then anyway, dog. I used to have... On every team, I used to be cool with the guards on every team that I played with. You know what I mean? So that's how that got there.
I never seen a player. I don't know how good he was or nothing. I ain't gonna disrespect the guy, but my name is Brian Chase.
Hey, that's serious.
Yeah.
What's your fucking name, man? You a
fan? We already, man. So I'm not Dirk Davis.
No, man.
I'm saying that's a little Dirk Davis.
No, dog. That's a fucking compliment. That motherfucker.
Yeah, right. Okay. I never seen a play. So to me, everything is the eye test.
He's all American.
I never seen that
motherfucker tough.
Okay.
I wasn't.
So if I wasn't an all American. But
See, that's poetry and emotion over here. Dirk Davis was buckets in motion.
That man hit the first shot of every game,
10th grade.
He wanted Joan all the time. So I don't take nothing he say serious until he gets serious.
No, I'm not Joan. I'm just saying, general, Dirk Davis is a bad motherfucker. That's what I'm saying. Yeah. And that's who your game reminds me of. That's not a bad thing what I'm saying.
Right.
That's a great motherfucking thing, what I'm saying.
Oklahoma State.
Yeah, it's had that accident.
That motherfucker
was bad.
Got in a car accident
down there, I think.
Yeah,
had
brain
damage.
Y'all put some clips of that game on Facebook when y'all played Gonzaga.
Yeah. Question for both of them. It's for both of y'all. Why y'all playing in the Legend Coalition?
Oh, man, I just told you earlier.
Why they playing? I love the game. He didn't answer it.
I love the game.
I'm definitely asking that.
Your phone messing up. You know, it's good camaraderie, man. All the guys, you know, you haven't seen in years, man. You get to rap, you know, too, man. Talk about, you know, what's going on and everything, man. But. You know, I'm good. It's a good thing you guys got going on, man. Definitely a good thing.
That's phone delayed.
Man, the whole reason I'm playing is this cat right here. They dropped Kurt name. I was like, are you serious? What'd that do? I called you the next day. I texted you the next day. I'm like,
are you serious, man? You playing?
I said, they ain't dropped your name because I ain't played in like 20 years. You ain't got no herbal stories about me. None of that shit. I ain't playing down there with them little ass God niggas and shit where you ain't going to get no shine down there. So I was like, fuck that. But they said my man Kurt playing. I called him. Bill gave me his number because Bill called me. He was like, Sweatsuit called me. He was like, yo, we get a little, he tried to dress it up. Yeah, we got a little league going
Bill
on. We're going to get out there and have fun.
Bill Brunfield probably blew your phone up.
Bill Brunfield. We were talking anyway about some training and stuff with
probably
the kids.
Until you answer.
Nah, I talked to Bill.
William Rivers.
Yeah, so he was like, Kurt playing. I was like, Kurt playing?
Oh, Bill Jackson.
So Kurt confirmed that he was playing. I was like, man, I got to come out.
I think at this point in time, we all know the game because you ain't ready to run on court.
No, man, because it's crazy watching y'all two play. It's like y'all playing together.
Man, that shit is on the same basketball team for 20 years. Respect, Rick. It's a calm when they out on the court. With Kurt on the court, it's a calm going on with me.
Y'all average 40 points a game, but even still, man,
I know the turnovers ain't gonna be like that.
I know my man, he was like, man, if this nigga can't score 50 points in a game, I mean, the crowd, the crowd, the crowd, listen,
if I went to college off the break coming to ninth grade year, me and Shree had motherfucking two motherfucking city titles.
I don't think so, bro.
Bullshit. Yeah.
Two or three. You might have got them early. You wouldn't have got them your last year. Fucking with us.
Well, that'd been a good game, but guess what?
Nah, that'd have been a great game.
A great game. What I'm saying, guarantee two.
Y'all had the bitches.
Yeah! Speak on that, dog.
Much love to all the coolest ladies. Much love, Miss Colts. Y'all the Colts. I remember that. But another thing I like about Coolies, y'all had a hell of an arena, man. That joint y'all had.
Hell yeah. I think we opened
during
up.
Our times. That thing that opened up was a class act. Yeah. That was serious. That was a serious arena they brought. To high school, man.
Yeah.
When they put that thing up there, man.
Played Summer League up there.
Yeah, that was special. That was special.
And Saul had his Summer League up there that year.
Yeah, because he was working up there. He came up there in my senior year. He was working up there.
Yeah, that's the year you left. I went to Temple that year.
Mo, give me your top five Syracuse guys, man.
Ooh.
Yeah, top man. Syracuse. And you can include yourself.
He's going
to include himself.
Yeah. Top five. At that one?
No, it's not just
top five. Okay, I like Pearl. I like Pearl. My man forever, Billy O. DC.
That's three.
John Wallace.
Four.
And Melo.
I'm going to tell you why
I got John Wallace in top five. We did 3 years together. And to this day, we the only two players in Syracuse history that he number three all time. He 2,000-point scorer. We the only two in the history, 2,000-point scorers on the same team. Yeah, he got like 2,100.
You ain't got Melo on there, though?
Melo was the last one.
Melo, Billy O, Pearl, Derrick Coleman, and J-Dub.
What's that?
Yeah. Give me that.
And I remember y'all had the show, and there was a couple of comments. They was talking about Melo, and he shouldn't be in like one of them top college things y'all had up, the top college players and stuff.
Yeah.
And I was like, that shit don't make no sense because he did enough in 1 year.
He was unstoppable that year.
You couldn't do nothing with
him. Be up there.
You know what I'm saying?
Melo is one of the top players in the college
situation. That was the question. And I was like, man, come on, man. This man, look at your feet. If your feet ain't pointing the right way, he raised up to him. That's how, you know, that's
his story. But he dominated.
True story, though.
Troy Weaver. Much respect, Troy. But I'm going to tell you this. Everybody knows, especially me and Troy. I'm going to say it today. I helped you make that phone call, brother. Yeah, I helped Troy Weaver make that phone call. It was a package deal. The only reason why Troy was at the Q's is unless he got my man Melo.
Send the bag.
So he made the call. Much love, Troy. Much love. We made that happen. And it was special up there. Slammy got it done in 1 year. You doing what you have to do. Shit, you on the GM. GM for OKC right now.
Man.
Much blessing.
They need to get him back in the Wizards.
Get Weaver down with his Wizards, man, and get some.
Some great business moves, man, because that motherfucker John Wall team knew better help. They good.
Throw the brick down. Nigga, that's what you want to do.
NBA, that's
going to be
crazy.
You a lot of money.
Hey, you don't think Melo should come here?
Who's left? It'd be great. It'd be great for Wall and Bill.
But they doing everything to be
great. In New York. For them.
What, at the West?
Yeah.
Basically.
They're doing everything through the draft. If they can land a free agent, they're going to land them. Mm-hmm. Other than that, they're going through the draft.
Mm-hmm. Who was the last free agent to come here big like that?
Gilbert.
Yeah, Gilbert. And my coach brought Nene and cats like that, second tier like guys. But
Gilbert was tough, man. He had a nice run. He brought him back. He milked him out. Four or five arenas with John Wall.
Arenas with John Wall.
But to be real, man, I was watching the game.
They rushed him back too, though. Not to interrupt you, but they rushed him back on the injury. That's why he never got right.
And then he bought the guns to stay in the
stadium. And I was watching the game.
Barry Farms.
Man, I was watching the game from the farms up there at work when
playing on Barry Farms.
He was on y'all team, man, and he was at the height of his game. He was on the court deferring to you two.
Yeah.
And that's crazy to watch on film, man. A lot of people don't see that, but in the clutch situations, he was going to you.
Yeah, it's been a team play out there.
But no, but that's just, he playing basketball.
Yeah, he balling.
You know what I'm saying?
That's all it was.
Yeah, he's been playing basketball. I mean, that's just what it is. I mean, he's a basketball player. He's a bad motherfucker.
And he trusted. He trusted Cass. That, you know, he recognizing that, you know, he got Cass that's rolling with him. That's rolling with
him. What he look like telling him, man, clip.
But come on, that nigga John Wall fast as hell.
And James Harden.
I mean, everybody brings something to the table.
And but watching John Wall in that
high school. If I had to take
John Wall like that.
One of those guys to choose from, because I already know y'all can go nuts. Give. It's dead.
I would go with Gil for the fear factor. Cause you can't, when he was on that shit, come on man, that man was like Kobe said, Gil.
Pause.
I mean, we watched James Harden. Gil. He took a lot of his stuff from Gil.
Yeah, Gil was tough.
The rims was a bad boy.
Yeah.
Come on, we know all the games that man finished before the break.
I think Gil was a more big time player than he is in the clutch.
That's my point.
He
score.
But when he gets up, he's sitting there shaking.
Yeah.
He can still play pick and roll.
I take a healthy Gil over a lot of people.
Yeah.
Gil Rams was a dog.
But man. Even still, healthy Gil, like that, healthy man. John Wall, I'm taking
Gil.
Yeah.
Because you can count on him for that bucket. You can count on him for that bucket.
A bucket.
How good was Billy Owens on the court, man?
Billy Owens was real special. I tell people, Billy was LeBron before LeBron. Yeah, on the Magic level. 6'9", D-Hodge, no, he played against him.
Yeah, we came
he know.
He was on our visit to Syracuse.
Absolutely. 6'9", 230, Magic, both hands, man, could do it all, man. You know, good dude, man. Much love for Billy Owens. He on Facebook. I know he on this, so he'll catch this. Much love, homie. He the godfather of my kids, man. All love, always.
What made you pick Temple?
It was away and it was close at the same time.
Right.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Then like Lawrence, I was
this thing got the alert.
Man, I was considering, like, I visited Maryland and what else did I went to NC State. NC State was sore second because I messed with Val Vino. That was my man. He used to call me every day.
He used to call me every day.
You know, one of my coaches got in my ear and was telling me about John Chaney, Terrell. He got in my ear and was like, man.
Rest in peace, my man, Terrell.
Yeah, he was telling me about John Chaney. And that was like the last thing on my mind to go up. Diggs, I really didn't even know nothing about him until like my senior year. When Mark went up there and he was number one and stuff. But I wanted to get out of the city and they weren't too far. You know what I mean? It was like 2 hours up the highway. So, you know. But I definitely want to get up with, you know, Georgetown. They kind of wasn't in the picture for me. Cause I really, in my heart, I didn't think John Thompson fucked with me at all. For real, honestly, you know what I'm saying?
They didn't recruit you at all. They did,
but they, you know, in my accountants, and you know how you can get this feeling about somebody that, you know, I would come out of AAU games and stuff like that, and I would go past him and stuff. He'd say something like real slick or something. About the game, and I'm like, you know, I might have took it the wrong way, but I'm like, this nigga don't fuck with me, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But then we down at McDonough Arena one time, and me and my boy that I shout out earlier, my man Stein, we down there, we go to the outside court shooting. This game's on the inside, but we on the outside court shooting and shit, right? And then, what's the white dude that used to be at the scissor? Estridge or something? He comes out to the court while we shooting.
Yeah.
He like, Don, why you ain't consider coming to us? I was like, man, I ain't think y'all fuck with me. Right. Straight up, just like that. He's like, no, it ain't like that, you know. And then I'm looking at my man, because we like NCAA rules, nigga, you ain't supposed to be talking to us.
Right. Yeah.
But he, you know, he asked me, and it was just like a misunderstanding from my part to John part. So, you know, I never had no shade against John. I just didn't think he liked me, so I really didn't consider him.
And then, on top of that, I knew Artie Winter was Alonzo more than any motherfucker. Where I was like, so I'm not going nowhere where nigga ain't don't fuck with. I'm not the number one nigga coming in. You know what I mean? Lonzo, that's my man, 100 grand.
You was old, but a motherfucking a nice motherfucker.
Come on, and the Kembe down there. Yeah, because I was playing against the Kembe on the down
with the Kembe in 3. Yeah.
Oh, no, man, no.
What was you about to say?
But yeah, that's why I ended up at Temple, man, because it was close. You know, I was coming home every goddamn weekend until I got used to it. So I got the homesickness out, man. But Philly was like my second home, man.
Really?
Was
3 hours
away.
I was
2 hours.
So why y'all didn't go to
Georgetown
as a
package?
I was just
home.
I like to say,
anybody
want to
go to DC?
DC, I could not leave the spot.
Why y'all didn't go to Georgetown as a package deal?
Huh?
What were
y'all
package deal?
They
were on their own. These motherfuckers. It didn't matter what school. It
didn't matter. It was a package. Carol Holmes. Our coach, man, much love. I don't know about Charlie's story, but my story don't like
it. Bartender!
Carol told me, I'm going to drop you off, Mo. One of the things I want you to do, I want you to tell him, John Thompson, you drove. I said, why you want me to do that? He said, because Coach Thompson, much respect, Carol graduate. JT always wanted to see people doing stuff on their own. You know, he wanted to see, you know, that you was a man. So he dropped us off. Drop me off up there, man. I sat down. What's up, boy? First of all, I ain't like that, because nobody in my family called me boy. So, you know, that kind of rubbed me the wrong way.
Yeah.
He rolled out, and Mariana Freeman, or Mary, the little white lady. Finland, the little white lady.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
Boom, she say, do you mind if I test you? I come there, man. I think I'm going to G-Town to get a nice visit, man. You know, walk on the campus, and man, they got me taking a test. So, it's the HEAR test. Two ways of using the word HEAR, H-E-A-R, H-E-R-E. They gave a sentence, and you got to put in the circle the right one. I'm taking a test, man, but at the same time, I'm saying, man.
On your visit?
On my visit, yo. I'm going to get the hell out of it. I can't. What the fuck I'm doing here? Make a long story short, my freshman year at college, man, I was looking at the USA Today, and if y'all don't know, Grant Hill wanted to go to Georgetown before Duke.
Wow.
But he said the reason why he didn't go to Georgetown was because of the test. And I fell back and said, oh, see, because I thought I was the only one that they gave the test. But they gave him the test, and that was the reason why he didn't go to Georgetown. Grant Hill wanted to go.
Did they give Vic Page the test?
No comment.
No comment. No.
I'm telling you, it's funny, man.
You took that test?
No, I didn't take that test because I told him everything he wanted to hear when it was right there. But
bartender,
I already knew.
Ice.
That man, this guy was talking every day when he was in prep school. I was like, man, you gonna go to Maryland? I said, Syracuse is the spot for you, man. Yeah, they've been on you since 10th grade. You know what I'm saying? And he went out there and did his thing, but it was totally different, man, back then, man. Like they say that John Thompson had tests where they bring out the books, and he's not the first person to say it. He's not the second person to say it. So I don't understand that part of it.
Oh, I missed that part.
You took the test too?
Huh?
Yeah, I never had to do that. And I'm quite sure he had a higher GPA than me up, Curl.
We got it done, man. We got it done.
Yeah, we were smart, but we got it done. But why would they do that? It's just like...
I sure
wouldn't
let me
to I want, ain't fit my style. Much respect. JT and
Bill. I got much love.
I hope they let me do well, Pat.
You got my
to pay them.
You got a Syracuse dude on staff, Pat. That showed me you got much love. Louis Orr. Much love, Louis Orr. And they played in New York
Louis
together.
And Boy show,
the Louis
right?
and Boy show. They played in New York together, man. So, you know, I ain't much love, man. But they didn't fit my style. Yeah. G-Town was more. If you wasn't a big at the time, you know, AI came and changed that. Yeah. You know, much respect AI.
But if he wasn't a big at the time, you know, he wasn't trying to.
Big Jew in the building. I see you out there, Big Jew. What's up, boy? Ah, my man, god damn.
Big Jew,
man. It's all love. Everybody out here, man.
I got you my top 7,000 of coolest Jew.
Big Jew, man. My god. Big Jew, remember we got in that car wreck before the game?
Oh,
this nigga had the Chevette, dog. Oh, let him put the damn red cup down. This nigga had a Chevette. I'm gonna tell y'all niggas, man. This nigga had a Chevette and we hit the damn bi-level button on the damn temperature thing, talking about that shit's turbo. We going to damn lunch. We got the broads in the back seat of the car running every red light and stop sign, man, and crashed into these cats, man. Took this nigga to the hospital, man. We laid in the bed at his house to the game time, man. This nigga came out. This nigga had a vision from God. This nigga came out the first man of the game, gave a nigga pump fake with baseline, so I dunk on the nigga. We like, god damn, you need to get a car accident every day. We said, ain't nobody never seen that shit, boy, from Big Jew. That's my man, 100 grand, man. Big Jew, man. See you soon, man.
Your point guard jumped in.
Oh, Clint, what's up, Clint McCoy? Big Boo, what's up with you, man? We need you tomorrow, man.
Oh, you know,
still driving that bus, man. We need you tomorrow.
You need one game to get crazy play to play.
Yeah, out. Man, we need all the coolest guests to come out, man. Especially some of them 22-year-old niggas that's coming in the league, man. Like them Cardoza niggas that beat us last week, man. All them 19-year-old niggas coming out running down the court looking like Brian Chase and shit, all fast. Come on, man. Come on out, Clint. And Randy Mills, all y'all, I don't know the rest of y'all little niggas.
I saw Randy work with him. He
worked
in the same building.
My God, I've been back and forth when on Facebook with him. I said, well, I'm trying to get him to come out. Floor, yeah. He said he was in a little shape, so yeah, you know, he's from my neighborhood. Yeah, Big Joe, peace, man. What's up with you?
Hey, he had a little panel with him tonight, man. Sorry, Charlie, man.
Bartender. Ice, we need ice there. Hey, Charlie Moe, go ahead with that.
Let's make an exchange. Get some ice and some cups.
You bring out some ice.
Get you in court.
No, hey, nigga, look right there. Look right there. Hold on there. Nicole on camera, y'all. How y'all doing?
Y'all done did these.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. No, I'm going.
Yep.
Yeah, man, this is nice, man. I'm glad y'all got this going on, man.
Yes, indeed.
This is going, hopefully this league that y'all started this year going for a long time, man. And, you know, hopefully it'll get to a point where you're not just, dudes not just coming there every weekend. You know, you can make this to a nice little event, man, when you start getting sponsorship and advertisement. So hopefully you know, trying to take it on a high level.
Win a tournament.
High level, man.
Yeah, so, win a tournament. Man, not a league, win a tournament.
God almighty, boy. This
is not a league, win a tournament.
All these old cats, boy. That was my main goal, to be able to walk on Monday after Sunday. When I was able to, I ain't had no pain on Monday. I was like, all right, that was a success. You know what I mean? Because like I said, I ain't been playing in a while. No. I talked to Kurt. He said he wasn't playing in a while when he was coming out. But even still, man, even above all and everything, it's a great thing. Like my man Sam said, Lon said, man, this is a great thing because you got so much knowledge in one spot. I mean, even from the guys that's not playing, you know what I mean? They know basketball. They know D.C. basketball. They know D.C., Maryland, Virginia basketball, man. And I got to give it up to the Maryland guys. Personally, watching them guys play.
Johnson Hill won that regular season today.
They play that ball, man. And it's hard to – you gotta respect it, man. Because I'm seeing these Maryland teams, and they got –
Remember, they have like five doors from each other.
But I just said, it's a point that.
Work out every day, man.
I feel you, but you know what I'm saying? I mean, but when do you see like.
Upgraded the neighborhood.
But when do you see a league
that's
play.
That's why basketball look like this.
Do it.
They
do
it. When do you see like league play where these guys are having an offensive possession, they passing the ball.
They're not in one
five,
league.
Six passes.
you know, without the ball going up there. Yeah. So it's like,
it's
you know,
only like two DC schools in the top 10 rankings.
Well, let's not get it twisted, too. I've been hearing them dudes been playing together.
They've been playing, but the whole
different
thing four, is...
Five
that years. Has nothing to do with
no,
it.
No, no, that got fuck that. My whole point is, it's much love. That's on the game. You're playing, you're getting your reps up, but to play in all the teams, you've been playing three or four leagues, you should play better. They do a good job of moving the ball. It's not bad.
And I said that just the same.
I respect their game play.
That's what I respect that. But at the end of the day, We gonna get that ass.
And them playoffs.
But yeah. Listen,
that shit gonna start in the front round.
They showed a good brand of basketball. That's what I'm saying. The coalition got it's good basketball going out there. That's my whole thing.
You have two divisions. You have the Maryland schools and you have the DC schools and the DC schools. Everybody got to play somebody from the other side twice, right? So then when they play each other, they trying to prove a point. DC trying to prove a point to them, and they trying to prove a point to us. Mm-hmm. But everybody that they play, they playing against the schools that they played against it when they was in high school.
Right.
So, therefore... It's very serious.
See, this is what I'm
it's
saying.
It's serious.
And it looks good. The league looking good.
DC got two winless teams. The two winless teams in the league are from DC.
See, but I don't look at it.
That's your observation of getting changed.
I don't look at it like DC.
That was some referee money.
Like Chase said, I agree, them teams ain't never won.
That ain't got nothing to do with it.
Them teams some shit.
That's what I'm saying. Them teams ain't had them stand out
for people.
You know what I'm saying? Good God, about these four people.
Basketball is basketball. Those are one to the DMV. I ain't on that DC, Maryland. I'm on basketball players. If you're a good basketball player, you're a good basketball player.
Yeah.
Right. When you start comparing DC, Maryland, and all that, man, we all in the same fucking circle. Mm-hmm. So it's all together. So I don't get twisted and all that.
If a nigga ball.
Yeah, basketball players. Is basketball players, whether you're from Virginia, Maryland, or DC, playing the center. So it ain't serious like that as far as the, you know, you're playing the game and you're going hard, but try not to get it twisted with you competing DC against Maryland or Maryland against Virginia. Fuck that. It's basketball.
I agree.
Because back when I was playing shit, Mike Tate from Oxford Hill, that's Maryland. Yeah, Monty Webb, Tone, that's Maryland.
Johnny Glenn, Steve Hood, Mike Summer for sure. I think what Moten and Donna was saying, like the league
so good, that's like a brilliant motherfucking situation.
Yeah, so now,
you know what I'm saying?
Because it's like family, yo. When you see cats and you ain't seen them in so long, right. And they come out there and they just embrace you, that thing is like vicious. Like when I first met Chase out there, you know what I'm saying? He came up and said, what's up? And I was like, I introduced myself. I'm like, Tree, man. He was like, I know. I was like, damn, that's love right there. You know what I'm saying? Because I knew of him. You know, because my man used to talk about him and stuff, that little Chase, my man, fasting, but I never met him before. You know what I'm saying?
So think about how many errors you got playing against each other at one time during each game.
That's the glory of it, though.
That's a beautiful thing.
That's
the glory of it. Cats is coming with it out there. That's the thing about it, too.
That's the glory of it, though. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
What y'all doing, man, like I said, it's so special, yo. If y'all really brainstorming, man, and y'all can take this to a whole nother level, man. We've been blessed to travel all over this world. We know a lot of people that play in different cities. You know, it could be a situation where the championship team
go against a championship team, talk to one of our dudes. Like, I'm good with Derek Coleman, a good friend of mine. Derek has a whole basketball league in Detroit right now. Mm-hmm. So my whole point is, they can get their championship team from Detroit and come here, or we go there and play them. So, you know, it's a whole networking game, man, where you can really expand this and take it to another level, man. That's what it's all about.
Yeah.
Just do it before a nigga turn 50. Y'all got 2 years, man. man, I think 48 years old, man. Come on, man. I'm coaching. That's what I told Bill in that first text. He's like, man, you gonna play? I said, man, I'll be a player coach more on the coach side. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, you know,
just a player.
But once you played that first game, you realize it really wasn't what you thought it was.
Yeah, I did a little preparation, but come on, man. I'm like 20% of myself out there. You know what I mean?
The pace is not crazy. It just depends, like.
Because you got other older cats out there, but then you got them young cats, too, that's running around. I mean, man, it's just crazy.
Yeah, that's man. Crazy, but, we got to deal with them youngins out there.
That's why I got my man right here next to me. He come to the game one time, we good.
Oh, that shit.
Y'all play before us tomorrow.
What's that going on?
Kurt out for tomorrow. He got another
engagement.
1:30. 1:00.
We play at 2:15.
1:00. 1:00.
That nigga say 1:00. That nigga crazy, man.
That boy, you be there on time.
And so, Kurt, what was your toughest match in high school? Who was your toughest, your toughest opponent?
Could anybody guard you?
Throughout your whole high school career in the city, who was your toughest opponent?
I don't think he's ever asking this question.
That's why I had to put him on the spot.
He was.
He's never asking this question.
And he deferred.
And I ain't even saying, like, you know, somebody that was a problem. I'm just saying tough. Because who was your toughest competitor that actually tried to compete with you?
First of all, I had no problem.
I know you had no problem. I'm saying, who was your toughest? You didn't ask me who was my toughest. You said I forgot how you worded it. But, you know, I said Morgan Wooper. But. Because I weren't tripping off nobody, but you asked me who my tough. There's a lot of tough guys. Like I said, Ricardo Lennon.
That was a hell of an LS you get.
They both said you want to play.
That was a hell of a way, you know what I'm saying? When you said Morgan, so you saying Kane White stopped you with a coach in a different scheme, right?
Yeah, basically. Yeah.
I mean,
bartender.
I had some tough opponents, though.
There were a lot of them, because, you know, the league was tough, and you played in a couple of leagues, because you didn't start off at the coolest. So, I'm talking about through all your leagues. You had some tough guys. I know you shredded them, but who was the toughest? Some of the toughest. You know,
man,
you can get
more
in
there.
Terry Lancaster.
You let this nigga all the way out the bag.
Nah, he weaseled his way out the bag anyway because he keeps shaking his head
No. Let him finish. Hey, don't cut me off, Terry. That was Sam. That wasn't me.
My man Lancaster.
Lancaster, what's up, baby?
Terry. Need a car, man.
I would actually say, you say.
Hey, Tree, this question ain't gonna get answered.
It's sponsored by Brownies, man. No, but like, just in high school, or just
high school, your high school career.
High school
toughest cats in the area. We ain't even gonna go outside the area.
Well, I'm gonna say my toughest matchup in the area was a guy by the name of Curtis Pride. Played in my AAU team. Deaf guy that played in Major League Baseball. Okay. Played in my AAU team.
What
you
got
there?
Right.
And
William and Murray.
No. Actually, went to a deep division one school. Might be William
and Murray.
So we went with Mr. Kitchens. Shout out to Mr. Kitchens, man. I'm in there with Keith Williams. I'm a younger guy, though. Keith Williams, Amy Tuck, and them guys. Just Curtis Pride coming in, man, and I'm thinking I got, like, everything to get, you know, just get past or move and I'm gone. That motherfucker was cutting that shit off and No, I'm saying just playing physical as far as
a defensive guy.
Defensive guy, that motherfucker, right? I couldn't do nothing.
Not letting you get to your spot.
Not letting me get no motherfucking win. Then, when I looked up, this motherfucker Major League Baseball player. Mm-hmm. You see what I'm saying? So I'm like, well, damn, I don't, you know, this motherfucker was like in that tip top.
You went to
God,
you
dead. With that shit, you know what I'm saying? From that perspective, I would say him, because this motherfucker wasn't going for nothing. Don, you know that shit, you in camp, and they tell them guards to pick up 94 feet, full court. He was that motherfucker. Like, he gonna meet you right there, right? And just...
Like a Gene Smith type thing with Georgetown, call that Georgetown press.
The shit was crazy, man.
Yeah.
I was coming to the point where you didn't even know what this motherfucker was. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Boom, I'm like, damn. So, I mean, it was crazy, man. You know, so from that perspective, it was him as far as, like, getting...
So that's when you, when I was in school, they was telling me, they said, the nigga Kirk down there, Dre, pulling up from half court. So that nigga the one who made you start pulling up from half court?
Yeah, they're living my dribble.
So this nigga Kirk hit.
Yeah.
He goes a step past half court and pulls up.
That's what he trying to tell this wild ass motherfucker right there. You know what I'm saying? Well, no bullshit, but yeah, that motherfucker was mean, man.
Okay.
But just you got to think of back in the Erdo tree, everybody was good.
Yeah, you had some good.
Yeah, some good teams. You know what I'm saying?
Solid team, like I said.
You can mention guys like Terrence Raycrow from Cadoza. You know what I'm saying? Oh,
come on, man.
Yeah, I mean you can mention
Terrence. That's my man. He came up to the coalition a couple weeks ago.
Any given.
I told him. I was telling Will. Shout out to Will Davis and Mark Salas and all them cats, man. Like I say, Greg Jones. But we was talking before the game, James Felix, that's my man.
Oh, yeah, James
Felix.
And Chris.
Come on, and Chris Felix, come on.
Yeah.
That man was Felix, you know what I'm saying? So we was talking about, I was like, man, we ain't had no answer for Terrence, man, when we played y'all. Mm-hmm. That nigga was swinging on the rim all type, and then Felix was swinging on the rim too.
Raycrow
was unstoppable, but then, you know you could beat him because you might come down court and you got guys on the team talking about, man, I ain't selling people. He ain't gonna pass me the ball. You know what I'm saying? So I'm like, oh, we got these cats, man. We just gotta listen to our coach, man. Because they evidently, their coach ain't got no control over them.
Right.
So, you know what I'm saying? it ain't not, you know, Terrence unstoppable. Like I said, we ain't got no answer for him, but if he's not getting the ball, like he might score, they playing take Terrence basketball. Mm-hmm. Now I don't understand what cats play that. You take Terrence basketball, like if Charlie Moe hot, he's supposed to get the damn ball. Until he's not hot, the opposition stops him. It ain't like Charlie Moore hit three shots in a row and now it's my turn to shoot. I don't understand that basketball. That's what they was playing back there. Like Terrence, we couldn't stop this nigga, but they stopped passing the ball to him. He stopped passing the ball to him, we catching up, and we got y'all, basically. If you ain't giving him the ball, our guards cannot check this dude. And he's doing everything, you know, everything just... We can't stop him. So why y'all not keep giving him the ball? Because the other guys on the team, like, oh man, it's my turn to shoot. It's my turn to shoot. That's not winning basketball. Shout out to Big T, man. That's my man. How they grin.
And you got back in the day, you got your mother. Did you get a chance to play against John Gwynn of the Mavericks?
Oh, that's why I was trying to say John Gwynn was crazy. Yeah, that's my man. Now he's out. He's my age. He came out with me. Yeah. John Gwynn. Crazy.
That motherfucker was tough. But coming from y'all, when y'all was at Carroll, who was y'all toughest opponent?
Yeah, John.
Who's the math? But you know, it was a type like.
Gonzaga was kind of tough.
Gonzaga was tough.
The church wasn't there, right?
Lamar, I take that back. Davis Willis.
Yeah, I take that back. We lost.
Horton, Dave Creedle, they was tough.
Yeah, they had
nice. We was always focused for them, though, right?
Mm-hmm.
But you know, that's like we walk in the gym, right? We had to stop having our games up curb. Cause it was like too many people coming to move the games. So we walk in the gym now, AU, right? Join the pack. We got our headphones on.
Y'all been Calvin, you come down too.
Yeah. Cut the headphones off.
That was our second home.
Yeah.
The whole crowd was quiet. Cause you know, Gonzaga was, that's Americans.
Mm-hmm.
American at Gonzaga School. AU. So we played them. Beat them there. Beat them up curl one time.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I'm saying.
Mike Sable.
I said we lost. We went undefeated in the season. We went down that thing feeling ourselves at Gonzaga. The game that count was a scrimmage. Them niggas tore our ass up. They got us refocused. You said Churchwell and all those guys?
Perry Carter?
Yeah, that's what we played when was at Martell. We played them in a tournament. But I'm talking about my senior year when we were undefeated in the season. We went down there and scrimmaged them people down there at Gonzaga. Them man ran us out the gym, man. I was like, hold, I'm glad this shit don't count. You know what I'm saying? Because these niggas is serious.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I thought that school was about to close down, man. These cats is out there running crazy on us, man. They definitely got us refocused for that year because we was feeling ourselves a little bit. But them cats, and all of them was like 6'4". They weren't no big cats on their team. They ran us up out of that joint. You know, we went down to their school to scrimmage. I only think we won a quarter down there. Them niggas ran us up out of that joint. Welcome. All right, good. Take this with y'all.
Metro Conference was tough though.
Even
Bone when y'all had Mac and Mob was.
And what happened? They just took basketball from Mac.
They closed the school down.
They closed the school down.
It folded.
Yeah. Ain't no one when they paying no bill, folded, no one when they paying no tuition down that motherfucker. Yeah, that child bill programs, who niggas they paying no tuition.
College dudes came with us, though. Big
yeah.
Shout out to Sidney Sheldon, Polish. Robert Frost.
Jamal.
What's
rest
up, Frost?
Jamal.
I saw you, man. Keep Drake going at 25 pounds, Slim.
Yeah,
you know the laws, man. Keep up the good work, bro. For real.
Straight forward. Buff.
Yeah.
What was Gonzaga? Yeah. I mean, not Gonzaga. What was Mackie
there? California.
Man, we in an alley.
up there with the wire.
That Jones in an alley.
Yeah.
That Jones in an alley.
Shout out to Royal Palace.
Shout out to Mackie, man.
Shout out to
Rufus. Folding to send my man up the coolest, you know what I mean?
That's your fire.
Mackie was
your fire. $3 million house right now.
Oh, that's some funny shit.
That's your fire. $3 million house right now. Going with $3 million, man.
Yeah, Mackie.
California Avenue.
Why you got that joint locked right there?
Okay, nah, Fickway
got a hand in that.
Sit real pretty up right
there. You know Fickway got a hand in that.
Real pretty uptown on the marble, all that marble shit. You know, I remember that marble shit y'all had up there, Mac.
Fickway got a hand in that.
You know, Fickway on the building.
Yeah, man.
Fickway on the building.
The house right there. They been out of house.
They might have a prep school up there, joint. Sponsored by Puma.
It's sponsored by Puma.
Nah, that was
back in
like that.
Yeah, back in Johnny Dawkins, man.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you can't just
Mr. Ash.
Shout out to Mr. Ash, no bullshit.
Ash.
Saint Emmy's ain't Carol and Mack.
Austin Cuff. Austin Cuff,
yeah.
Mack.
JoJo Hunt.
That's my man, JoJo. Mm-hmm. JoJo to this day is throwing up numbers on cats. It's not a game with him.
JoJo, huh?
Seriously. JoJo is still giving cat fits.
that's no bullshit.
Just like Black Leonard DeBella giving cat fits.
Delonte Taylor in the coalition.
I heard Delonte playing well out there.
That's what's up.
Yeah, these cats ain't playing.
Delonte, you gotta stop wearing them sandals, though, man.
One thing about Delonte, he take that shit serious, though. When he step out there,
it's
old demeanor. You know what I'm saying? That motherfucker take the game serious. He talked the game in a great way, for sure.
Yeah, Booney out there.
Oh, shout out to Booney Green.
What does Booney be playing with? A weight vest?
My little
young. Booney playing a weight vest. Man, he had all this under. Man, he
had now, Booney's coming prepared, man.
He like he's Secret Service today, son, man.
They got a good record. I ain't know that record was as good.
Five and one.
They lost
the Dumb.
They lost the Dumb by the first week.
They put an asterisk beside that. Baby Shaq wasn't there.
Well, put
that one there.
One and Wednesday.
Two and four.
2 and 3.
Dang,
I ain't trying to look. Model on, man.
Two of the best guards in the nation.
Man, how they? I got two guards that's under 25, man. Sneaking these cats in the league, man. Come on, man. I'm dead serious, man. I'm going back to Cardoza, man. Goddamn, Cardoza ain't never had that many niggas to go to school up there, man. Every nigga I know went to Cardoza and dropped out, man. Come on, man.
Nah, he's a poser, man. All jokes aside. He's a poser, man.
So Trey is still playing, man. Trey is still playing in a league somewhere. Where it's Europeans. That man is still playing in a real league, man. That man is 20. How old is Trey? 32.
You gotta be 30, man.
Even if some of them Maryland niggas, the nigga out Lago is the little guard that shoots the threes out Lago. That nigga is in his 20s.
He just turned 30.
He just turned 30.
What, after the league started?
He's 30 years old.
Right before the league started.
So you know what I'm talking about? You're about your height.
He's 30. Nigga that's shooting the threes. He's 30.
For what school is that?
Lago.
Lago?
Yeah. He's 30 years old. Can't get the dice for.
I guess niggas is really old. Niggas. 30-year-old niggas. I guess 30 years in their 20s, like Jay-Z said. These 30-year-old niggas is moving around. Well, I moved around when I was 32, though. But God damn, these niggas is fast, man. For all the time, I'm 48.
So. Trey Kelly dropped 40 the other day.
I believe you. That nigga's in his 20s, man.
But Boo 30, and nobody say that. Boo, me and Boo the same age. He's 30.
Boo Jackson
is 30. Who's the one for Suitland scoring all the points?
That nigga look like he like 50 though. No shame. It's all love because he put up numbers last week. When I watched the play, made an excellent game.
No disrespect.
No disrespect. It's all love. But I thought he was my age. You know what I mean? I thought he was 48. You know what I mean? Say, I look young for 48, but God damn, I thought he was my age. He just turned 30. Good for you. God bless you. He balling though.
He only scored another 40 one game.
That nigga, he's serious. That's the guy that went to Bowie State or something, right?
Yeah.
Oh, he got game. He's made.
Gabe Dunbar 43.
He made you. He made you.
What that got to do with anything?
Boy, he sent a lot of shots to Dunbar, though, boy. Good God Almighty. He sent a shots your way, boy. Good God Almighty.
Listen. Hey, when Curl was 0-2, all the shade was towards them.
Nobody dominated when we played them. We just couldn't get a rebound. Him. You in the way.
That's all.
So that was the most boring game in the history of the coalition.
It was.
It was 30-33 or something like that.
I left when it was 10-11.
Y'all get on my nerves.
It was the worst game,
man.
We just trying to get wins.
So y'all going over what time y'all leave when we lose?
Man, because everybody on our team is legitly aged. We got motherfuckers that's in their 40s on our team, dog. We
legitly aged.
You know what I mean?
Is that a word?
Legitly. Aged. You know what I'm saying? We are legitly aged. Mm-hmm. We are old cats. We OGs in our neighborhoods. Mm-hmm. Playing against 20 niggas, man. We gonna
everybody
even Stacey Robson. What's my man name to do the games? Stacey. He's like, man, y'all gotta check these guys. Check these guys. Check the birth certificates and everything coming in here, man. Because there's new guys coming in every week.
We already did that. Mm-hmm. But at the same time.
Yep. Man, I'm telling you, I'm going back to Lago. I'm going back to Lago. The little nigga out Lago shooting all the threes.
He's 30.
He's 30. They got a nigga that's like 6'6". They got a nigga that's 6'6".
But you don't think about the league.
Oh, no. The nigga from...
You got Chucky. He's
shooting threes.
He got a couple looks. He was knocking, man. But they got another dude that's like 6'6" on their team.
Lago.
This nigga is all of 23 years old.
They're talking about Jamal, right?
He's all of 23 years old.
Me.
But you see, you got to talk to Adam.
I'm just playing, y'all.
Talk to Adam and Silver, man.
I'm just playing, man. Because it's all love, though.
Man.
It's all love.
He's
the GM. That's
right here. Yeah, you know what I'm saying, Mo?
So the birds is here. Nah, I'm just playing. It's all love, dog. I'm just playing, man. I love all the teams out there, man.
They know what's going on.
It's all love.
He's the real GM. They know what's going on.
You missed the game. He missed two.
I ain't missed nothing.
And y'all lost the last two.
Yeah, we're going to pick it up. We got to get
No, Kurt missed one.
He missed one, I missed one. And we lost both
last week.
He missed Cadoza.
Count me in with two.
I heard he was ducking Greg Jones.
He missed two because he's not playing tomorrow.
Tomorrow. Well, I mean, tomorrow's
we got to question the commissioners about that because we got teams that ain't playing the same amount of games.
You got to win for seeding.
It's only one.
Yeah, that's
you got to win for seeding.
But if we win tomorrow and they don't play tomorrow.
Oh, yeah, that's the learning process, man.
We
the
don't.
But Parkdale's not the issue.
You know what I'm saying, bro?
The GM.
Blair's the issue, man.
Blair, that's crazy, though.
Blair's the issue. That's crazy. In terms of the process.
But.
If y'all win, I'll still blow y'all.
Off of your overall points.
Your record, then your points.
And I need that by
for records.
I just saw 356 with us.
Yeah, but y'all had three.
Y'all points. Sitting pretty, though. Carroll's sitting pretty.
Not anymore. They lost.
Oh, they lost today?
We at 304.
Yeah.
So if we at 304 and we score 60 points tomorrow, then what? Don't worry about it, because everything is based off your record and your points.
Suitland 3-3, but it got 440 points. So.
And we got way more points.
Clarence Boone.
That's my point.
Oh, Boone trying that?
I
don't know, GM. All
right, don't worry about it.
Mr. Boone Green.
Don't work your
y'all to get it together.
My man.
It's a process.
It's okay.
We're just going to go into it and do our thing. There ain't too much to say, but this is going out that thing and playing, man. Y'all but I just think I just wish goddamn Father Time ain't just had it one knock on the door like that. God damn.
It's a double tournament.
Watching the tournament, it just came off with this. Yeah, that's a good luck, man.
Watching the tournament and.
Talking about the coalition?
Yeah. And one idea bounced off of another idea, and then this idea bounced off.
And what's going to happen is this, too. I don't mean to cut you off, bro. Win a league, doing it during the winter too.
Win the league, cats gotta recover, man.
Too much.
Nah, I'm telling you.
Nah, look.
Do it during the
winter. Man, show over, man. Win the league. At the end of the day, hey.
Listen, I got a question about the commissioners of the league. How did y'all feel about the turnout of the first week?
Man, the first week was crazy. It was standing room only. I mean, you couldn't get in the gym.
Couldn't get in. My wife couldn't get a seat.
You couldn't get in
at all. You know what I mean?
And it was also like that the other day when Victor Page played.
Oh yeah.
There was nowhere to sit.
I mean, you got a good turnout.
And you know, and the best part, I try to tell the guys is they don't care whether you score 2 points or whatever. Yeah. They just want to see you guys in uniform.
Yeah, that's the whole thing. I mean, coming out.
All the Curl alumni was out today.
I can't speak for Curl, but I know we coming out. I know myself, I come out for like them old cats, man. And there's some niggas that they can just get up and down the floor a little bit. That's all. You know what I'm saying? I saw my man, like I said, shout out to Cedric Lewis. I saw him last week, man. And we was talking. He was like, man, I wish I could get out there. My back killing me, though. I said, man. I feel you, man.
That's a good match on St. Louis, too.
What's that name?
St. Louis used to chase that shit. That little,
Sid,
glass that shit.
Sid coming out there. I never played with Sid in high school. I ain't played with Sid because he was a year ahead of me. I never played against Sid.
You was around Moose, I was a term matchup,
though. Yeah, we used to go at it. And we used to talk. Because, you know, like I said, brothers from another. Yeah, that's my man.
Yeah.
He used to talk. But
that was the ideal matchup back in the day. Like, the Moten and Lonnie.
Uh-huh.
That was the matchup back in the day.
He said ain't no matchup.
Yeah, but that's the same way I feel, though.
He said ain't no matchup.
You know what I'm saying? But, you know, it was something to do. You know what I'm saying? Definitely was something to do.
Let her have you on the show, huh? Moonstar.
Gerard come up on the show.
Let her have the show.
He's talking about the high school level, though.
What matchup you talking about? You yourself?
I don't know. I don't know no
match up, man. Ain't no comparisons,
this,
man.
It's
don't
just
put
balling, like you said. It's just balling.
Like, you know, man. Books, man. Put it in the books. Man. The books don't lie. That's all I'm going to say. The books don't lie. All this jibber jab about what niggas doing. The books don't lie, man. The books never lie.
Yes,
sir. So don't try to make your career off of this shit here.
Hey, the
for real. This is a competitive league where guys gonna love to play the game, get it in, stay healthy. That's a blessing,
that's the
too.
Whole thing. That's
staying
the whole
healthy,
thing.
Like they all said, man, you, guys right? Get to run up and down and get the hoop on, man, and all that. But if you're getting emotional, man,
you got
a problem, Slam. You really got a problem. Love the game.
If you get emotional, you ain't did shit back in the day.
Yeah, because I mean,
you ain't did shit back in the day.
Especially if you were legitimately over the right age to play in this game. legitimately the right age to play in the Legend Coalition. Your ass ain't getting drafted in the league. So, if you're not 19 or 18, your ass ain't getting drafted. So don't be out here trying to fight a nigga or getting all in your feelings right. Like a little right. Hoe right. About if right. He elbowed me. Right. Or, not getting a contract.
Billy Bob fried me last night. Yeah. Billy Bob ain't do shit in high school.
Baby, Billy Bob fried you and he going to work tomorrow. There ain't no scouts coming down this motherfucker to get your ass.
We said he was in the green,
man. We got Brian Chase and Trey and all them young niggas that. Knowledge in that gym, and that's where it stopped. Niggas gonna be like, oh yeah, he out here balling, good to see him. I'm glad he looking healthy, nigga looking good. This, that, and that, but don't get in your feelings, man. This is the Legends Coalition, man.
Enjoy the Legends game.
But guess what, though? Guess what? When that motherfucker posted that shit up, they gonna do first team all met and all that.
That was
dead. I said, you about to have some shit fucked up.
Extra elbows coming to pop.
We the original first team all mets.
Yeah.
When we was doing the motherfucker.
Everybody took the picture.
Man, these niggas right now, when I said, oh, shit.
Nah, but what about my bad D4? D4 went on some cats out there. You see his post?
He said,
it's good to see some of the guys, the best guys that ever did it. But some of you motherfuckers just snuck in on these
teams. I was like, D4,
no.
You're right, D4.
D4 went on them niggas. That's why I said D4. You go ahead, man. He said, it's good to see Cat. This is the first weekend. I think me and him was in the pitching. We was dapping each other up. And he was like, it's good to see some of the best guys in the area, some of the best that ever did it. But some of you motherfuckers that just snuck on squad. You know what I mean? I ain't got nothing to do with that statement. Yeah. I mean, that's his statement. That's his point of view from the shit.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? I had a good laugh off the shit. Not my feelings for all the guys who snuck in. You know what I mean? Y'all just snuck in. But that's not how I feel. My perspective is there's some legendary role players. So they had to come in too. So D4 is not... that totally accurate with it,
everything's
good. It's a good league, man. We all having fun. That's what Bill. That's how Bill sold me on. He said, "Guys, we come out, get together. We're gonna have fun." And it's been fun, man. It's been fun. I mean, a couple of defeats. That ain't been fun because we want to win, but everybody want to win. But that's competition, man. So we going to it. Nobody getting their feelings. That's ball, man.
Absolutely,
for real.
You know, everybody just representing the shit.
Basically, it's a good deal.
Ain't no names on the back of the jerseys or anything. Whatever school you went to,
Them niggas even gave me the wrong really number. They ain't got my right number, so I ain't gonna be right till I get the right number. Them niggas gave me 33. My number was 35, man. Yeah, it's crazy, man. That's Brad Chasing them doing that.
Adam Silver.
He said he was calling me that week, man. I just did that.
I ain't did nothing.
He paid. That's what, man. He paid. He fucked me.
But it's for everybody. It's for everybody.
D-Pain is the captain.
Yo, we don't get into that because D-Pain had his own issues with the coach. Somebody in the first week, he was like, "You are not the coach."
We'll talk when we finish, man. This for everybody.
If D-Pain the captain, we can get a check for every game. We can throw in the lead.
The whole point is we get all back to the community, but. People don't understand that it's a lot of people that came through this city before people like myself, even youngers after me. So now we got a younger and younger and younger and younger crowd coming to City Games.
Yeah.
What they owe is they bring their kids. That's the whole point, because basketball didn't start with this AAU whole situation where they playing AAU. You can't go see them play all the time.
Right.
It's fine.
And y'all still packing gyms at 40. That's crazy, yo.
That's fine.
It's crazy. Don't say 40. It's for us. 50, 40 plus.
But it's for us because
yeah,
everybody, like literally, that's sitting here, and I don't even include myself. Y'all laid the bricks.
Mm-hmm.
What?
I'm fucking.
See what I'm saying? Y'all laid the bricks at the end of the day.
Yeah.
For myself. So if y'all laid the bricks for myself, then I had to lay another brick or a couple more bricks for somebody else to come pause and lay some more bricks.
Yeah, 20-hour time.
I mean, but and then, you know, the part that meant to me, I was with Chris Wright the other night. He said, man, as soon as I turn 30.
As soon as I turn 30, I'm playing the league.
And that's what it's about.
He said, as soon as I turn 30, I'm playing.
How old is he?
He's 28.
28, 30.
Right here, he came tomorrow? Shit. Really? He's all the niggas at Cadoza. And at Dunbar. The only nigga old at Dunbar is
the
all
that. Oh, see, I'm good. See,
the only nigga Daryl Brew and my man Sean. Those the only cats that is some age at Dunbar.
I want to ask Charlie Moore and Moat a question as far as like right now, as far as to see your alma mater, Carroll. You know what I'm saying? Like to struggle and not be like same level y'all were. You know what I'm saying? But you know what I'm saying? Any of y'all ever thought about taking that job or trying to see what's up with a job?
It's basically like Carl was before they got there.
they were just too old to get the job back then. They were thinking about some other shit. Carl ain't been doing shit like that.
Earn Jordan, much love, Earn. We're gonna stick with you.
Really, what are we talking about?
Michael Bird. Okay. It was tough times.
Bird, that's my man.
Dirty Lewis.
Any of y'all talking about like trying to get that job?
Well, you know, hey, if it's opening, it's an opening from what we're hearing, man, and we would love to come back and help out our alma mater, man. You know, there's no question about it. You know, it's in God's hands, man. He'll take everything. If it's meant, I know if I happen to get a position or if I'm blessed to get back to my alma mater, like I would definitely love to do, I definitely know that I will bring back a winning tradition.
Definitely.
Because that's in my blood, and it's all about recruiting. One thing I do know, too, is, Bone, a lot of guys, man, that went to Carroll, their kids going to Gonzaga and the Mantha.
Mm-hmm.
Some of the things they tell me is, man, if you was up there working or we had some Carroll people,
Name alone, you know how it go, man.
If the opportunity arises, you know, and we're there, you know, we definitely gonna change that thing around for sure. Yeah. And the guys that's there now, Rob Harris, I played with in football. He got the football team back on a little winning track, trying to get them back, man. So, you know, it's a process.
Yeah, their football team was like the, that was like the first Notre Dame, man. I used to watch them play every Saturday. Notre Dame.
Three out of four championships at Carroll, baby, football. And I'm talking three out of four.
Yeah, and I'm talking about as a kid, I used to watch them play. I used to play games on Turkey Thicket Playground. Absolutely. You know, right across the street from where I live. Exactly. And I was a kid watching these cats play on the week. I'm like, God damn, those cats is like, it is.
No disrespect, I don't like Carroll.
Yeah.
We lost y'all last week. But at the same time,
talking about the present.
My man.
Yeah.
He's
talking about the present.
You ain't bring the crab.
I didn't like them niggas either when I was growing up.
You ain't bring the crab.
Ain't had none. I got my man sitting right here. Yeah. I love him to death.
Yeah, much love.
Al Clark, we are related.
Yeah.
Somewhere totally different. All right, so y'all can go ahead and finish having y'all.
No, but now you know.
I was about to say that, bro. Moe was on the same team. We played the same team. ABA.
Me being young and him at the, like, coming back from overseas and at the end of his career, I always listen. It didn't matter to me. Like, I can listen. If you tell me something, I don't care how mad I get or how stubborn I am. If I see him look at you and your eyes pause and you tell me, man, nigga, shut the fuck up. Do this or do that. All right. If it's going to help us win, I'm going to do it. And that's what he did.
Right.
Yeah. When he actually got to, because we had already started playing. Mm-hmm. But for me, it was just like, all right, I knew he was. Yeah. Okay. Now we about to dominate.
Yeah, you had to see
but he really, though. But he really came back and helped, and he helped teach more than anything. He ain't dominate. Mm-hmm. He just helped teach. But he still was efficient.
And that's, that makes it basically dominant.
He was, he dominated. But he was a player coach, and he wasn't a coach on the team. So I never played for his team. We was on the same team together.
See, what I say, I seen the play. I seen us play together 10th through 12th grade, John. I was like, it's time. And we didn't even have to be like, let's go Slim, enough. It was all tough, eye contact, out of bounds play, boom, bang. And we gone. After that, it was like, everybody else waiting? Nah, we gone. We press, we get the ball, we gone. We didn't have to go through all this talking and shit. Mm-hmm. Of course, we communicated. Like a timeout, up on the floor.
I ain't friend. You go,
I go, or we're gonna do this shit together. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. You got the mismatch. We ain't give a fuck who was scoring the most points.
Right.
That's what's different now.
The objective is to win.
Yeah. Everybody looking at stats.
I'm not even gonna lie to you. We won.
Mm-hmm. You gotta win.
I mean, obviously we lost in the game to go to the championship, but you look at the games that we won, we won a lot of games. All it was mentorship, leadership.
Dudes knowing their role.
Everybody did their job.
Yep. Yeah, man.
Hey, Mo, you remember the playing up tech in open gym sometime with Coach Mo now?
Yep, I sure
back in the day, and this is no bullshit. I ain't never told you. That's the first time I ever seen you play basketball, man. That shit was crazy. I grew on that one day. You might have been like in the eighth grade or going to the ninth or some shit. Right. Motherfucker ain't missing that one shot. I mean, I'm like, who the fuck is this motherfucker? You know, back then, you know, you been recruited. High schools as recruited like college type shit. So they take you up on a visit. You know what I'm saying? You hooping.
Coach Moore
and them, man, back in the day, they was doing a great job with that.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Biggest schools.
Yeah. I seen your guy. I was like, man, I said, who is this motherfucker? This motherfucker was boom. I said, who is this young motherfucker?
That's funny, yeah, man. Because we never, up Curl, I ain't going no visit.
Right.
I went up Curl because my cousin was there. Mm-hmm. And me, Malcolm, and Jamie from my neighborhood was going there.
Mm-hmm.
Then when I seen this nigga orientation, I saw, man, we about to fuck this shit up.
Yeah.
He played with Sacred Heart.
Sacred Heart.
Uptown, 16th Street. Much love for the
Puerto Ricans up 16th Street. All love, Sacred Heart Church. All that. You know, but yeah, man, I'm good times, though. You bring about some good memories, Bone, you know. Hard work, man. We had good teams, you know, but it was times where I can honestly say that, you know, guys, I remember seeing guys like wait on us to make our move, you know, yeah. before shit can happen.
Yeah.
You know, because 50 points, it was 50. No matter what, we could lose, we guaranteed 50. So that was a blessing, man, to have another dude that you know when shit was tough.
That's when the coach was
give it to my man, and you knew he was going to get a bucket. That's a special feeling, for real. Yeah. When you know you got a partner that, when you struggling or shit going on, and you kick it to him, he going to get that bucket for you.
Yeah.
And I always tell him, my man Charlie Moe, one of the prettiest jumpers, you know, out of all the guys I've ever seen, man. One of the prettiest jumpers. Yeah, I've seen a lot of pretty jumpers.
That's real talk.
Yeah,
all right.
One of the prettiest joints,
DJ. Gonna play? Is he
gonna come on in. One of the prettiest joints.
Yeah, all right.
We're gonna try.
Respect
those,
Sam.
We're gonna get my man out there for the playoffs, man. We're gonna get my man out there for the playoffs. We're gonna make our backcourt debut.
They said Mike Graham came up with the Popeye's chicken upstairs. Mike, shout out Mike Graham. That's my man, dog. You know what I'm saying? It's all love. That's my man. Mike, shout out, man. I'm right here, man. Big treat, man. We that motherfucking chicken over here, man. When you pulled that thing out, I was done, man. I was like, that nigga gangster, dog.
I was just messing with you.
Yeah. We
gotta
gain them up.
All jokes aside, though, man. Like, for me, everybody sitting right here, it means a lot because at the end of the day, I said it earlier. Y'all put bricks down for me to put another brick down. Y'all, you think I'm playing? I don't give two shits about making no first team all met or none of that shit. I'm talking about when I was in high school.
Because you already did, though.
No, talking about when I was in high school.
Your game spoke for itself, though.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. It didn't mean anything. Y'all just made me want to compete.
Next year.
You understand? So, to be sitting right here, it means a lot to me to be on the panel with who I'm sitting on the panel with. At the end of the day.
Same thing. Like, that's what like motivated me when I was a young cat, man. I had man Dave Butler, man.
Yeah.
This man was top five in the country. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm talking about? And I'm just like, I'm in awe of all that shit. I'm seeing him go out there like an animal, man. That made me, I'm at home. But I'm doing homework and all this other shit, trying to get on the court. You know what I'm saying? But and I'm in my basement lifting them little fake ass weights, you know, the little cement, little joints. Doing little curl, skinny little nigga. But I'm all in my mind, like, man, I gotta get with Dave Butler. Is. This nigga's a cold animal out here. You know what I mean?
He's playing hard as hell.
Yeah, man. And to this day, I just envision that nigga like a third play of every game, man. Gotcha. With Mahoney coming down and throwing that thing off the backboard. Hey, and you just say Dave Butler screaming.
Did you play with Gerald? Did you play with Gerald? Are you rest in peace?
Gerald went the coolest too.
Andre, that's my man.
Who his favorites is Tim Anderson, though.
Oh, man. Hustle Man. That's the original Hustle Man. You fit. This man hustled so much, man. He was the first Robin, man. Yeah. I'm trying to tell you, man. This man, wherever the ball going, he going. If that thing going in the first row, you got to pick Tim up out the first row. He balled. He had a high IQ. That's my man. Tim was ahead. Mm-hmm. He had a lot of IQ guys on them squads, man. From guys that was a little bit older than us. Mm-hmm. Especially they had the coach. Frank Rams had them guys in order. You know, and he was one who got me in order. You know what I mean? Up there, you know, just correcting things. You know what I'm saying? Paying attention to detail and stuff. You know?
y'all look different from us, cause y'all who's had a tradition. Carol always had a tradition, but then it went down to like
when we came up.
Football was tradition.
Football.
It was mean, football. Yeah. Football was mean.
Then like when we came up there 10th, we started making some noise. 11th, we ended up winning that joint in the conference. 12th, everybody knew who we was. It was like we made a big ass difference up there. So the whole scenery was different. It was football and basketball now.
The worst thing that Carol did, well, I don't want to say one of the worst things, was getting the female.
Yeah, it was crazy.
That was the best thing y'all
did. Man,
I
this nigga
the streets from y'all, motherfucker. Cut it out, bro.
Hey, man,
that was the best thing y'all ever did.
Y'all had down the
city, man. I was at Brooklyn Station. Wait, what the hell are you talking about? What is he talking about? I was at Brooklyn Station. Wait. Get off that bus. That H2 bus. Come on, man. I know. I
think
that's good. Come on. How are you doing,
though? I was at Brooklyn Station, and I'm all the way up there.
And I went to summer school. You know y'all was going.
Hodge at Brooklyn Station, I'm all the way up Coolidge.
Yeah. When y'all did that co-ed thing, that was the best thing that Carol ever did.
Nah, man.
I'm trying to tell you, man. If you can ask anybody in the Brooklyn or in your office area, I was 19. They was 18.
No, you already went pro when Carol went pro.
No. Oh, yeah. I'm thinking of summer school then. Yeah. I went to summer school up there. It was co-ed in summer school.
Summer school.
Yeah,
man. My man D. Hodge all the way at Brooklyn Station. I'm all the way up Coolidge by the IMAX.
Tacoma.
No, that was the best thing they did, man. Come on, man. Hey, Catholic school girls is like that. We ain't talking about basketball no more. Catholic school girls in the goddamn skirts. Vicious. Love messing with little niggas.
No disrespect, you McCoolidge, honeys.
Oh, yeah.
No, buddy.
But, yeah. Cool business,
Hey, I don't mean to be rude, man. I gotta check out, man. I got a long drive tomorrow. Going back to Syracuse, do my camp up there. But I will be back for the playoff game because I got the camp for the kids the following week. And I heard the playoffs is in 2 weeks.
Stay away, Lawrence.
So bring your A game, come playoff time.
We don't need no motherfucking
ready niggas. Much respect to what y'all doing, man.
I'll tell you like this, girl. We don't need no more record-breaking niggas coming to the league. He's right amazed, but he still got buckets. Yeah. Stay your ass up in Syracuse. We don't need 30 points to come down to the league.
What's up? We done?
Yeah, we're going to close this out, man.
Love,
great show,
love,
man.
Love. I had a
great
ball,
show. Five first-teamers, man. Yeah. No bullshit, though. Yeah.
Take the picture. We flow like the water. All met right here.
No bullshit. Can't take that away, man.
Records don't lie.
Can't take that away, man. Thanks for everybody supporting the Legend Coalition, the Red
all
Cup.
All DC, everything, man.
It's more to come next week, man. So appreciate y'all. We see y'all next week.